live from Valdosta's Cleveland Field, the Georgia High School Quad A State Championship pregame show. Brought to you by McDonald's. What you want is what you get at McDonald's. Adidas, makers of the new Mutombo basketball collection. Adidas athletic shoes, they're all you need. And by Pizza Hut. Hotlanta's calling for Pizza Hut.
And we are live from the sidelines here at Cleveland Field. This is where I will be spending all of my time once this big Quad A championship game gets underway, and that's going to be in about a half hour. You can hear the band warming up. Of course, the players, Valdosta players, out on the field warming up too. Clark Central's still out there. This is going to be a whale of a contest. And for more on how this game shapes up, let's go up top to Randy Waters and Fred Khalil. They'll be calling this contest. Gentlemen?
Thank you very much, Joe. And as we look at this one, we're going to have to keep our eyes really peeled for number one for the Valdosta Wildcats.
Number one, Steve Everson. They have built the offense around him. It's a wide veer because he likes to attack and go to the perimeter. You see him against Dunwoody. So much misdirection. Fakes everybody out. That set up a field goal, and of course, Valdosta went on to win 10-0.
Clark Central is a powerful football team. Not much deception, although, Fred, you think they might do a little gimmickry early in the game to try to take the crowd of it or whatever, get some momentum. But for the most part, they've got some kids who can chug it up the middle. And speaking of numbers, number one for Valdosta, we've seen Stacy Bailey wear 35 for Clark Central. He's going to be wearing number six tonight.
He'll be wearing number six tonight, but he wears 35 in the video that we're going to show you. He is a load. They put an extra back in there and do kind of a weird configuration of a power eye, put two tight ends, and bam, they just come at you.
We will keep looking for that. As Joe Washington told you, he's going to have the story from down on the sidelines. Right now, let's go back down to Joe.
Okay, Randy. Well, the Clark Central team left Athens yesterday after a great pep rally and a meal. They stayed in Macon last night and bused down here, got here to Valdosta, a couple hours before game time. Now, of course, in Athens, they're used to football. They're used to the Bulldogs, but they don't ignore their Clark Central Gladiators. And there's a little conflict going on there sometime, but there's loyalties to both teams. Let's show you.
The football program is pretty simple. The folks around Athens point to one man.
You hear a lot of boys who played for him in 74 and 75, and you'll see them at a game and they'll say, I played for Coach Henderson. They're proud of that. Some people, they don't say I played for Clark Central, so I played for Coach Henderson.
Billy Henderson is a Georgia Bulldog who returned to Athens nearly 20 years ago after a successful stint at what was Willingham High, now Southwest Macon.
He was such a outstanding coach against us that I told Don Height that's who I would go interview, and that's what Don Height did. They brought him up and interviewed him the next week.
And the rest, as they say, is history. Three state championships, 18 consecutive trips to the state playoffs. But it's his 1975 team that brings back the fondest memories.
But 1975 was very special because we were 0-4 the first four games. And somehow or another, these youngsters rededicated themselves and won six straight in the sub-regions and really set the standard of excellence that's been enjoyed at Clark Central for so many years.
If 1975 set the standard, then 1977 was the payoff year, the first state title. Charles Campbell was on the team that beat Valdosta.
I sacked Buck Ballou in the end zone for the safety, and we won 16-14. And being that this, they playing Valdosta, now, you know, it brings back them memories, you know, and it feels good.
There's plenty of history here. Clark Central is the former Athens High, where it all started for athletes like Fran Tarkenton and Andy Johnson, who went on to Georgia and the pros. That's like ancient history to these youngsters. Some of them can't think about anything but the present.
The football team gives us strength, you know, as far as, I mean, I guess it makes everyone have a positive attitude. Most people look up to the football team, and I think they also help people strive harder.
I mean, that's all everybody's talking about. You go all around the school, everybody's talking about the football team and going to Valdosta and talking about especially last Saturday's game.
The Gladiators surprised a lot of folks by making it to the championship game. Despite their winning tradition, the community's been slow to show its enthusiasm.
Now, unlike Valdosta, which can put 6,000 fans in the seats on a bad night, Clark Central sometimes has to overcome some obstacles in getting community support. Earlier this year, it was a slow start. One game, only 500 people showed up. The other obstacle is between the hedges. Getting people to divide their loyalties between a successful college program and a perennial high school powerhouse is tough.
We understand the nature of the Athens community. As we approach the playoffs, they really get interested and support the team in the stands, but throughout the year they support us financially, which is very important to us.
They support Billy Henderson and his kids because of what Henderson brings to the table. He cares.
He said, well, I got a problem. I got one kid that's got nowhere to stay. And I've got to, you know, find him a home. And Billy and his wife, Foskey, took that young man into their home and kept him for quite a number of weeks.
If it were just the game itself and the score, it wouldn't be enough. But day by day, you get involved in these young lives, and it becomes a drama. I learned a lot of things from Coach Wright Baseball. I've learned a lot of things from Coach Nick Hyder. It has to do with people.
All right, Billy.
Photographer Richard Crabb and I covered a lot of ground this week, and of course we made the trek down here to Valdosta on Monday, and we found the city, well, not really nonchalant, but I guess you could say kind of pacing itself for getting as excited about this game. After all, they've been to the championship game 25 times, so you got to learn to pace yourself. Let's take a look at what it looked like in Valdosta earlier this week.
Team here, on the 89 team that wiped out Clark Central.
I've got on the button the last time we played Clark Central. My daughter was a senior. I've still got this button. It brought me good luck. I'm still patting it. We gonna have good luck tonight.
At 8 o'clock tonight, we can send them all back up north with a bad look on their face, and I think that's what we're going to do.
Actually, that was the pep rally from this morning. Now, let's take a look at the way things were going here in Valdosta earlier this week. It was a little quieter.
You've no doubt seen it and read about it. The Valdosta Wildcats have spent the season near the top of the national rankings. So what else is new? If the Wildcats aren't in the running for a championship, something's wrong. At least that's the impression you get in this South Georgia city of 40,000. But there's something you need to know about the community. The place that boasts of the Crescent House as its most famous landmark doesn't want to make a big deal about its real claim to fame. The welcome sign announces the area's two largest employers. No mention of the high school football team that has won 21 state and 5 national championships.
They don't get all excited. We don't have pep rallies like we used to have there. We have them occasionally, that type of thing. But it's all done now to, we play football after school, but the youngsters enjoy it. And you can see the numbers that we have out. That's the thing we're proud of.
But make no mistake, they are proud of hosting another championship game. When you've been among the elite for so long, you learn to pace yourself. Fan momentum is as important as team momentum. So the signs of encouragement around town early in the week were few but visible. While some merchants like Ivy Player base part of their livelihood on Valdosta's athletic success, they tend to take the cautious approach.
We look forward from one year to the next, one game at a time, and that's the way Coach Hyder likes us to do it, and that's the way we sort of accept things. We try to win each one of them that comes along.
And there's only one right way to do it, and that's the together way. It's the unselfish way. It's the way we get things done.
And they've been getting it done since 1913, a national best 701 wins. These are only a portion of the trophies and team mementos representing Wildcat success, from the first state title in 1940 to the most recent in 1990. The national awards, the legendary Coach Wright Bazemore, and now the all-time winningest coach in Wildcat history, Nick Hyder. Around here, success breeds success, but they'll tell you it's all about priorities, not football.
School comes first. From 8 to 3, it's in the classroom, and then we'll go to the football field.
But among the students here, nearly 2,000 of them, pride is mixed with envy of the football program. Still, it's football that's bringing out the best.
It encourages everyone else to work harder because it's in the back of our minds that maybe if we achieve something at the level that they do, that we will get the same type of recognition.
Now, gentlemen, this coach is proud of you guys. This coaching staff is proud of you, and this town's proud of you.
And when we return to Cleveland Field, we'll take a look at the Georgia High School Association and its role in high school athletics. Stay with us.
Just because the 80s
duties are over doesn't mean you have to stop looking out for number one, especially when Chevrolet makes it so easy for you. For instance, for a limited time, Chevrolet has made it possible for dealers to get you a new Lumina equipped with the extras you're looking for, but without the extra cost. Now, who said the 90s were going to be dull? The sure thing is going on now. See your participating Chevrolet dealer.
This season, Pizza Hut's giving you something to celebrate. The Holiday Stuffer, a pizza loaded with 10 great toppings. Pepperoni, mushrooms and olives, Italian sausage, ham and bacon, beef and pork toppings, onions, even green peppers. Now at Pizza Hut, try one medium for a special price of $9.99. Any second pizza's half its menu price. But you'd better hurry, because when the season ends, so does the deal.
For free delivery, Atlanta's calling 662-5555.
Milk. You know milk's good for you. Drinking milk helps build strong bones and teeth. But did you know that the latest government research shows that the calcium in milk helps prevent certain types of cancer? And calcium combined with magnesium and potassium, all found in milk, can lower blood pressure. Or that milk is rich in vitamins and minerals needed for healthy skin and eyes. And protein to build muscle tone. Drink milk for health. Drink milk for life. A message from the Georgia Dairy Farmers.
Adam Keefe, 6'10" Atlanta Hawks power forward versus Josh Mary, 3'10" fourth grader. Adam runs rings around his opponent, so does Josh. Adam's a master slam dunker.
Hey, that's not fair!
Adam drives the lane. Josh drives a great deal from McFrugal Auto Rental.
I rented from McFrugal Auto Rental and saved a bundle. Did you know McFrugal rents new cars at the best rates around?
McFrugal Auto Rental, America's best neighborhood car rental company.
Who's next?
Tonight's game is being simulcast on several stations around Georgia. It's part of an agreement reached in the last year with the Georgia High School Association. What is the Georgia High School Association? Well, it's kind of Georgia's version of the NCAA. Sports and several literary events. The Georgia High School Association oversees that and more. To get to the heart of this 99-year-old organization, you travel about an hour and a half south of Atlanta to Thomaston, where the GHSA has been headquartered since the mid-1940s. The offices were originally housed in a laundromat. Sam Burke was executive director, the first of three executive directors Ann Story has worked for.
It has changed an awful lot. When we first started and I worked for Mr. Sam Burke, we had just a few sports, and now we've taken on a lot of different things like soccer for both boys and girls, cheerleading, wrestling, swimming has doubled, and our tennis has probably tripled.
She's part of a staff of five now administering high school extracurricular activities in Georgia, along with administrative assistant Joyce Kay, registrar Brenda Wright, new commissioner of officials Ralph Swearingen, and executive director Tommy Gillibo. A combined 70 years experience is represented on the High School Association staff. Gillibo sees an expanding role for his organization because of the 96 Olympic Games.
The Georgia High School Association is going to have to grow. The activities that are offered in the Olympics certainly will receive some emphasis down at the high school level. I'm sure we'll see something on swimming. I think it'll be a bigger sport. I think soccer will be a bigger sport.
This is the first year of varsity status for volleyball, and cheerleading will stage its first championship in 1994. The GHSA took a major step this fall by appointing two women to the executive committee. Cedar Grove principal Marianne Schreckengost and LaGrange athletic director Lois Myers are a positive sign for girls' athletics in Georgia.
I think that by showing the public that we're there and we're going to support females, that maybe more people should come to their games, market them, so that the public becomes aware that there's some good athletes out there and we need to be out there watching them.
We just hope that the local people will get out and support their local schools and student activities and get involved with your local school. That's the way you make great schools, is to get great involvement.
And in addition to athletics, the GHSA oversees one-act play competitions, debate, You name it, it's involved in all of that. Now, with me again, Executive Director Tommy Guillebeau, and one of your dreams was to see this state high school championship, all the games played in the Georgia Dome, but it looks like we're still a ways away from that.
Yes, we ran into quite a few conflicts in that, Joe. The first of all, of course, the Cuppenheimer Classic came in at the same dates that we have our state playoffs, and they had already set a contract on that, and I understand they've set a contract for the next year. And since we schedule every 2 years, it's difficult. We'll have to plan 2 years ahead of time in order to get the Georgia Dome if the communities ever decide that's what they want to do.
All right, so it looks like we're still a ways off. Thanks, Mr. Guillebeau. Hope you enjoy the game.
Thank you.
You know, Marietta's Amael Jackson was considered one of the top prospects in the state coming into the season, even though he was coming off a knee injury. Well, injuries would continue to plague the running back. Late into the season, he broke his leg, and he'd be sidelined again. It looks like now, despite the injuries, he may now be headed to Clemson. Now let's take a look at the rest of our college prospects, because remember at the beginning of the season, we started a list for you, and Corey Bridges, he's up to number one. Corey Bridges from Noonan, looks like he's going to Miami. Jimmy Clements from McEachern, he likes Florida. Derek Stiegel of Noonan, he has verbally committed to Georgia Tech. Mike Bobo, the quarterback from Thomasville, could be headed to Georgia. Byron Capers, the running back and linebacker from Wheeler, he has made a verbal commitment to Florida State. Andre Short of LaGrange, the free safety, Mississippi State, looks like a possibility for him. And T.J. Johnson, the running back from last year's co-AAA champion Lakeside, he has verbally committed to Georgia Tech. Now, we've got a guy here who spent a little bit of time on the Valdosta sidelines of late at Georgia Tech. Valdosta alumni Coleman Rudolph, and of course, you've got dreams of the NFL right now. You're looking at that and the Senior Bowl, but just what has this series meant to you? Because you played in a championship game in 1986 against this Clark Central.
I think, you know, it's a big rivalry, North versus South. And, Clark Central always had a great program and great coaches, and it's just a bitter rivalry that we're going to see unveil once again tonight.
Well, Coleman, stick around. We look forward to talking to you again later in the evening. Thanks a lot. When we get back, we'll have a preview of some of the other championship games going on tonight. Stay with us.
It's McDonald's Holiday Film Festival, now featuring the American epic Dances with Wolves. The original full-length video, unbelievably priced at just $7.99 when you buy any large sandwich. So hurry in and pick up Dances with Wolves. Also available, the family favorite, Babes in Toyland, and the hilarious Dirty Rotten Scoundrels. These films just $5.99 each when you buy any large sandwich. What you want is what you get at McDonald's today.
Ladies and gentlemen, feast your eyes on the elegant J30. A classic luxury sedan in an infinity kind of way. A driver's car with two airbags, soft leather appointments, and tasty wood. Hey, pal, don't you even think about it.
For a J30 signature lease, see your infinity dealer today.
Tell them what it is.
1992, Behind the Hedges.
We gotta have it. Good job.
Giving you a rare look at a side of Georgia football you never see.
And even if Mike Jones and our team were lined up today.
From the strategy to the sidelines.
We got man every time, brother. Every single time.
Hastings caught it. Touchdown.
UGA, the 100-year season of Bulldog football. December 30th at 10 p.m. on 11 Alive.
Just about every day, something happens to make my day, and the other day was no exception. Went to see a friend of mine, 82 years young, living under a fixed income. This lady just loves to help folks, and she surprised me. She had gone out and purchased 10 canned goods so that she could take part in the holiday canathon that we sponsor every year. Can't stand to see children go hungry during Christmas, she said. She wanted to do her part. Don't you?
Drop your canned goods off at any Kroger store now through December 31st.
Championship games going on tonight in all classifications. Randy Waters starts us out with a preview of single A.
The quarterfinal between Macon and Clinch Counties featured two goal line stands by the former that meant a 20-7 victory for Macon County. Then, the semifinal matchup against Darlington of Rome. It was a runaway, due in large part to a runner named Mario Hankerson. Hankerson had 176 yards rushing. He scored three times in the first half as Macon County earned a trip to the finals with a 43-7 win over Darlington. The matchup in the quarterfinals between Bowdoin and Monticello was at the Hurricanes' Rose Bowl field. The weather resembled the home team's nickname, but it didn't slow down the offenses in the first half. Clarence Protho runs it deep into Hurricane territory, and the Bowdoin Red Devils were in business. Quarterback Randall Kerbo sneaks it in for the score. Then Curtis Koch gave Bowdoin a 14-6 lead when he gets in for six. Then Monticello battles back. Kenneth Ross, the reception and run that keeps the Hurricane drive going through the rains. And the touchdown run was something to see. Terrence Davis takes the pitch, takes off, gets to the corner of the end zone, quite a run. But in the long run, Bowdoin had too much and wins it 35-14. The semifinal, another offensive show with Bowdoin getting a 20-0 lead, then having to go to the air late to beat Charlton 32-27. The Eagles are flying high in Camilla, Georgia. Mitchell Baker has been top-ranked in AA all season. Fifth-year coach Jack Johnson is favored to win his second state crown since 1989. Mitchell Baker has reached the finals by trouncing Vidalia 28-6 and overcoming tough Lubbock 21-7 last week. The Eagles soar on the arm of senior quarterback Jake Rackley and the running of number 40, William Barnes. Barnes has already rushed for 3,000 career yards. He's only a junior. The offense is so potent that it overshadows Mitchell Baker's defenders. The Eagles' first-string defense has allowed only three touchdowns in 14 games. Mitchell Baker will host the championship game in Camilla against the lads from Sandersville, Georgia. Washington County's Golden Hawks have had one golden season. Coach Rick Tomlin has them 14-0 and rolling. Washington reached the finals following a 21-14 win over Franklin and last week's 20-0 shutout of Early. The Hawks' main weapon is number one, Robert Edwards. Half the SEC is recruiting this running back, including Georgia's Ray Goff, who will attend the ball game Saturday night. Edwards leads a Washington team that has never gotten this far before, but nobody's stopped the Hawks yet.
In 3A, Peach County earned its place in the title game by beating Thomasville in the quarterfinals. Then, Saturday night in the semifinals, upset Mighty Marist in Fort Valley on the Trojans' home field. Junior running back Kalen Jackson scampers 25 yards for the go-ahead touchdown as Peach County smells a victory. But Marist came roaring back before stalling inside the Peach County 5 as time ran out. Peach County 34, Marist 28. In the other bracket, Thomasville Central advanced to the championship game with wins over Appling County and previously unbeaten Stevens County in Toccoa. Trailing 14-6 in that game, the Yellow Jackets scored on the pass play from junior Ricky Stacy, the backup quarterback, to Johnny Cooksey, cutting the lead to 14-12. Then, Thomas County Central converts the two-point conversion. Stacy to Doss Bozeman, tied at 14. We go to overtime. The final play, Stacy lets it fly, complete to Paul Mavala, 75 yards for the score. Thomas County Central advances 20-14 over Stevens County. Tonight, it's Thomas County Central and Peach County for the AAA Championship.
Valdosta's Wildcats rolled into the quarterfinals against Northside Warner Robins, having given up only five touchdowns. The Eagles scored one more in a 17-7 loss. By the time Dunwoody came to town for the semifinals, few doubted the Wildcats would move on to their 25th appearance in a state championship game. But Dunwoody's Wildcats were looking for the upset, trailing only 3-0 at halftime. Then, with 2.5 minutes in the game, Steve Everson connected with Shadrick Green for 45 yards and a touchdown to sew up a 10-0 win for Valdosta, setting up a seventh state finals matchup with Clark Central. The Gladiators have matured in the playoffs with two straight come-from-behind wins, first against Marietta. Clark Central fell behind the favored Blue Devils 16-0 in the first half. Then, with the running of Stacy Bailey, came on strong in the second half for a 26-22 win. The next week, Warner Robins came to town and made the Gladiators pay for some early turnovers. At halftime, Clark Central trailed 21-7. Stacy Bailey scored their only touchdown of the first half. He would score right off the bat in the second half as the Demons' turnover problems began. This one went to overtime, and Clark Central won it on the penetration rule 22-21. And we'll take a look at some past Quad A champions right after this.
I like the sound. sound of a big, juicy steak.
We've got a big, juicier, more tender than ever.
Sounds good. The sound of a sizzle. I just can't wait.
And three new ways to love them.
Sounds good.
We've taken a great steak and topped it with thin, crispy onions, sautéed mushrooms, or zesty peppercorn sauce. Want more? Our famous salad bar is free. Each just $7.99.
There's nothing like the bond between a man and his truck. And right now, taking the plunge is easier than ever. It's a sure thing. For a limited time, Chevrolet has made it possible for dealers to get you an S10 pickup, equipped with the extras you're looking for, but without the extra cost. Yes, there's nothing as perfectly matched as a man and a truck. Unless, of course, it's a woman in a truck. The sure thing ends soon, so hurry to your Chevrolet dealer today.
Well, honey, another day, another gallon.
Ooh, how about 6 gallons? Mm-hmm. Now that's 660,000 gallons a day between all of us Georgia peaches.
Well, moo me.
From moo to you, Georgia can thank us for over 10,000 jobs.
Moo, moo, moo.
The milk industry contributes $700 million to Georgia's economy.
Well, moo, moo.
Now that's something to moo about.
Utterly amazing.
Mm-hmm. A message from the Georgia dairy farmers.
Well, no matter what, there will be a new champion in Quad A football in Georgia after tonight. The folks who were in it last year, well, they didn't even make it to the playoffs this year. And that's LaGrange. LaGrange, the 1991 champion. They didn't, like I said, make it to the playoffs. Valdosta, though, was the winner in 1989 and 1990. Warner Robins won it in 1988. Morrow, which made it to the playoffs as a result of a vote of the coaches in the sub-region this year, they won it in 1987. Valdosta won it in 1986. It was Clark Central in 85. Valdosta before that. Tiff County in 83. Valdosta won it in 82. 1979, Clark Central. In 1978, Griffin and Valdosta played to a tie. As we've told you before, Valdosta and Clark Central have a heck of a history between them. And tonight, it's only going to add to that. You can hear the drums in the background. The fans are getting ready for the players to come out. The players are ready for this one. And as we've said, the coaches are real nervous, but real happy to be here. All right, I'll continue from the sidelines during the game. And, of course, we're going to have Randy Waters and Fred Khalil up in the booth. This promises one to be one of the great events in high school sports history. First time ever a championship football game has been televised statewide in Georgia. Stay tuned for a live telecast of the 1992 Quad A Championship Final.
The pregame show has been brought to you by the Heartbeat of America, Chevrolet, and your local Chevy dealer, the Georgia Dairy Farmers, and by AT&T, a proud corporate partner with the Georgia High School Association.
The Bob Hope Christmas Special and Christmas in Washington will not be seen tonight so that we may bring you the following local presentation. These programs can be seen in their entirety Sunday night beginning at 11:35.
This season, Pizza Hut's giving you something to celebrate. The Holiday Stuffer, a pizza loaded with 10 great toppings. Pepperoni, mushrooms and olives, Italian sausage, ham and bacon, beef and pork toppings, onions, even green peppers. Now at Pizza Hut, try one medium for a special price of $9.99. Any second pizza's half its menu price. But you'd better hurry, because when the season ends, so does the deal.
For free delivery, Atlanta's calling 662-5555.
In an historic one-hour special, ex-Naval Officer Montel Williams travels to the San Diego Naval Base to salute the families of our troops in Somalia. Hear the dramatic stories from America's military families as they talk candidly with Montel about their hopes and fears. In this incredible first-time event, Montel gives these families the opportunity to send video greeting cards to their loved ones in Somalia. a holiday card to the troops on the next Montel Williams Show.
Monday at 9 on 11 Alive.
His name is
Fred,
and he does sports. Why don't you
check him out?
That's right.
Check out Fred.
We asked you to give him a try, and you did.
Fred.
Here's what you told us.
I'll check out Fred.
Fred's awesome.
We switched to Fred.
Welcome to the South, Fred.
Thanks.
Great sports.
My dog's name is Fred.
What?
If you still haven't checked out Fred Khalil Sports,
why?
Come on.
Check out Fred.
Fred Khalil, weeknights at 6 and 11, only on 11 Alive News.
Check out Fred.
Tonight's Georgia High School Quad A State Championship game is brought to you by Adidas, makers of the new Mutombo basketball collection. Adidas athletic shoes, they're all you need. AT&T, a proud corporate partner with the Georgia High School Association. And by McDonald's, what you want is what you get at McDonald's.
There is a sign in the locker room here at Valdosta that says 48 minutes to play, a lifetime to remember. And that is oh so true, because for most of the players on this field tonight, this will be the crowning moment of their football lives. Good evening, everybody. I'm Randy Waters along with Fred Khalil. We'll be in the booth for you. Joe Washington will be down on the sidelines tonight as we look at this Quad A championship between Clark Central out of Athens and the host team tonight, the Valdosta Wildcats. Now, Clark Central will pretty much try to chug it up the middle against a very good pursuing Valdosta defense.
They'll go with a weird configuration of a power eye, put an extra back in the backfield as a blocker, sometimes two tight ends, and give it to this guy, Stacy Bailey. He's wearing number 6 tonight. He has worn 35 in the past. Wearing number 6, he averages 7 yards a carry.
Clark Central had two stirring come-from-behind victories, one in the quarterfinal, one in the semifinal game. Now, the big play in the overtime win in semifinal was a blocked punt by Frank Battle. He'll wear number 91. He also does a lot on defense, not just special teams.
He's a defensive end, and he made 42 tackles from his defensive end spot this year. He'll also sometimes step back and play a linebacker as Clark Central goes into what is really a 4-3 look.
Keep your eyes peeled for the Valdosta quarterback, and you'd better really keep them ready because Steven Everson can scoot.
Steve Everson, they built the offense around him. It's a wide veer, and he runs it wide. But don't be surprised, Randy, if Everson and Valdosta comes out throwing the ball. I think they might come out throwing the ball, trying to loosen up the defense, and then that will really open up the running attack.
Now, on defense, Valdosta, they boast about their speed. They say, look, we've won these mythical national championships. We've won 21 state championships. It's not because we're so big. We don't grow them any bigger down here. That is a myth, they say. It is simply because they are well-disciplined, well-drilled, and they pursue very well. And a guy who does that to the extreme is number 44, Marcus Williams.
Marcus Williams, 106 primary hits. To say he is a headhunter is an understatement, because he will hit you, he will fly after the football, and the entire Valdosta defense will throw several different fronts up tonight, and they are going to pursue and really get after it.
All right, we're just about ready to go. This will be a packed house tonight. They say 12,500. They get a few more people than that in here, I do believe. We'll see when we come back for the opening kickoff after these messages.
Milk. You know milk's good for you. Drinking milk helps build strong bones and teeth. But did you know that the latest government research shows that the calcium in milk helps prevent certain types of cancer? And calcium combined with magnesium and potassium, all found in milk, can lower blood pressure. Or that milk is rich in vitamins and minerals needed for healthy skin and eyes. And protein to build muscle tone. Drink milk for health. Drink milk for life. A message from the Georgia Dairy Farmers.
It's McDonald's Holiday Film Festival, now featuring the American epic Dances with Wolves. The original full-length video, unbelievably priced at just $7.99 when you buy any large sandwich. So hurry in and pick up Dances with Wolves. Also available, the family favorite, Babes in Toyland, and the hilarious Dirty Rotten Scoundrels. These films just $5.99 each when you buy any large sandwich. What you want is what you get at McDonald's today.
I know. You see all of these car and truck companies announcing their end of the year sales, and you think, this is no time to be spending money on a new car. Well, Chevrolet couldn't agree with you more. So for a limited time, you can get a new Chevrolet or Geo for a great low price. Even better, you won't have to start paying for 3 months. I think that's very nice of Chevrolet. Don't you? The sure thing ends January 10th at your Chevrolet Geo dealer.
Matumbo Bull played in the house of Matumbo by Matumbo. Matumbo Bull played in the house of Matumbo by Matumbo in his Matumbo shoe. Listen, you don't have his game and you don't have his house, but you can get his shoes in your size.
Back to Cleveland Field in Valdosta, Georgia, where Clark Central will receive. Valdosta won the toss. They deferred until the second half. And you can see these two teams certainly are familiar with one another, and Valdosta holds the upper hand. Billy Henderson at Clark Central and Nick Hyder at Valdosta, no strangers. There's Billy Henderson, and both of these gentlemen, we'll get into this more during the flow of the game, but both of these guys are more than numbers. However, just to impress you a little bit, Billy Henderson, 203, 50, and 1 in his 20th year at Clark Central High School in Athens, of course. And Nick Hyder at Valdosta, well, you probably read and heard about him, 19th year here. He's won 6 state and 2 national titles here at Valdosta. They won 21 times the state championship, Fred, going for 22 tonight.
And this is going to be a great game. Let's just tee this thing up and go. I tell you, this is, the excitement has been building, and Valdosta is going to kick it off and play defense first. We'll get a chance to look at Marcus Williams and that defense of Valdosta.
All right, Kendrick Hall and Eric Hurd, as Nick Hyder looks on from the Valdosta sideline, and he admitted that he was just too nervous to talk about this game at all today. He said, check with my assistant coaches and my people around me if you want to know anything. There are the people deep for Clark Central, Kendrick Hall and Eric Hurd, as Alan Sanderson gets set to kick it off for the Valdosta Wildcats, and the Clark Central Gladiators set to receive. So we will crown a Quad A state champion coming up here in roughly 2.5 hours or so from now. And again, these kids, some may play college, some may even play professional football, but for most, this will be the football moment they remember most the rest of their lives. We're underway. And in high school football, when the kickoff goes into the end zone, and Eric Hurd took it there, when it goes into the end zone, it is an automatic touchback. So the Gladiators will put it in play at their 20-yard line. We'll get a chance to check out their offense. They are led by senior quarterback Palmer Bush, and he has some rather big and rather experienced people around him.
Mike Harper, since playing just offense, he had to go both ways for a while. He's number 58. You see him right there. Since he's played just offense, it's really, really improved the offensive line of Clark Central as Valdosta comes out in their 5-2 look.
Ricky Smith and Eric Hurd in the backfield. Rip Kendrick, where's number 14, has been ailing a little bit. We'll have to keep an eye on that situation. Is looking to throw on the rollout as Bush off the hands of the receiver Kerlin Payton here on the near sideline.
He was involved in man-to-man coverage with Jason Jelks because Marcus Williams went ahead and stunted. He went ahead and did the blitz, and that really put him on man coverage. That ball should have been caught.
Look at the skill people you saw there momentarily. Harper, Smith, Osbolt, the big centers, the guy who anchors that line. He is a major college prospect. Webb and Ward at the guards for the Clark Central Gladiators. Second and 10 from the 20. Palmer Bush handed off the backfield, a loss of a couple of yards by Ricky Smith. The kid broke a couple of long ones against Marietta. He had nowhere to go on that particular play. Franklin Wiseman, the tackle, and he's one of the best for Valdosta.
He'll come from his defensive end spot and make the play. Watch the stunt. The stunt is on. You saw 92 move, and then you've got 49 right there, Franklin Wiseman, and then he made the play because of that stunt. I'd call it what's called a zip charge, where they just run right toward the center of the football.
Well, Clark Central, where they did not want to be, on foreign turf, third and long on their first possession, third and 13. Pro set for the Gladiators. Payton in motion.
Throw play. Draw.
Push.
Hands off. Draw. Ricky Smith. Up to the 23. Well shy of the first down. Sam Thomas to stop for the Wildcats. And so Valdosta will get its first chance, barring any trickery here on Clark Central's part.
I think Clark Central did the right thing there. You say, why call a draw on third and long to be safe? You don't want to commit a turnover deep in your own territory and give it to Valdosta at the 25 going in with an interception or a fumble.
John Bell is back deep, and Eric Hurd to punt for Clark Central. Bell back to receive for Valdosta. Here's Hurd. No pressure, gets it away, not an especially good one, and Bell lets it bounce. It'll roll down inside the 40-yard line, so Valdosta with excellent field position at about their own 38-yard line.
This is what we're waiting for to see this guy, Steve Everson, as he gets some final instructions from Coach Nick Heider. And again, I would not be surprised to see him early in this drive go ahead and try to throw the football. See, he's got 11 touchdowns running it and 10 throwing it.
Pretty good balance.
Oh, I tell you, this kid's tough. Looking at Vanderbilt right now.
All right, the man who was back on the punt is out wide left. Alfred Barnes and Tommy Speed are the running backs. And here we go on the first play from scrimmage. Valdosta keeps it on the ground, and Tommy Speed gets very little. Kevin Johnson the hit for Clark Central. Let's take a look at Valdosta's offense and see how they line up. We talked about Everson, Barnes, and Williams. Williams averaging over 5 yards a carry. The receivers, Rocky and Bell and Shadrick Green, will be at tight end. Chris Gingrow, Alan Holt, Brad Grant, Jesse Hunter, and Harvey Moore, the offensive line for Valdosta. None overwhelmingly big, but that's what they teach down here, cohesion and quickness, and that's what gets it done for them. Second down play on the option and the pitch. Tommy Speed, not much there either. Left side driven out of bounds by Ben Daniels, the cornerback who came up. And here's Clark Central's defensive line. Frank Battle, the man we mentioned in our opening comments. Derek Jones, Mike Harper, Godfrey McWhorter, and Nick Heider said, I'm scared of that kid. And the secondary, the linebackers rather, Kevin Johnson, Anton Goldwire, Ben Daniels, Eric Hurd, Jeff Greer, whose father, Steve, coaches at Georgia, and Reggie Lewis in the secondary. Third and eight for Valdosta. Everson's going to keep it, and he's going to be in trouble.
Great read that time by Clark Central. Mike Daniels made a great read on that play. They tried to string him out. He didn't bite. Big, big defensive stop for Clark Central.
Let's take another look.
Now you can see Mike Daniels. He'll be the option man, number 55. And look at that. Gets off the block and makes the play.
Eric Hurd showing his versatility because he punted moments ago for Clark Central. And he is right now one of two backs to catch the punt for the Gladiators. Reggie Lewis back there along with him. Valdosta to kick it away. Wayne Devane gets it away. Again, not an especially good one. And it is a Clark Central bounce back up to about the 38-yard line. So the Gladiators, that's where they will have their second possession. So we are scoreless here in the first quarter from Cleveland Field and Valdosta. Clark Central and Valdosta in the Quad A championship game.
You know, I really felt like Valdosta might come out and throw the ball a little bit, but Nick Heider, I guess, as you said, Randy, nervous for this game. Maybe he just wanted to get a series under his belt before they come out and try to do anything fancy.
All right, we're going to be back here after you have these messages from your local stations.
First came the light. The composition. When you capture an image this special, you need the special quality of Eckert Ultralab 35. 30% larger prints and two rolls of film for the regular price of one. For the pictures of a lifetime.
Cub Foods deli experts can help you celebrate any occasion with scrumptious platters and desserts. From delicious seafood platters to colorful vegetable trays to mouth-watering meat trays and assorted cheeses, your guests will love any party our deli serves up, and you'll love our assured minimum prices. We even have cakes custom decorated for any special occasion. So pick up this colorful party pamphlet at Cub Foods today.
Shake it up, make it up, make it up, pop, 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 p
Don't miss Upton's 14-karat gold jewelry sale. 60% savings on all 14-karat gold jewelry. It's a golden opportunity to buy those last-minute gifts. So get just what you're looking for just before Christmas.
Hold on and listen up.
Name someone famous you consider very boring to listen to.
President Bush.
Because the new Family Feud will leave you speechless.
I get so excited when I try to say it.
So tune in and find out what everyone's trying to talk about.
Tell me something that's really hard for some people to say.
I love you.
All this week on the new Family Feud.
Family Feud, weeknights at 7:30 on 11 Alive.
Scoreless in the first quarter in Valdosta. Clark Central to put the ball in play just over the 35-yard line. That punt bounced on the far sideline and went out just past the 35. Palmer Bush brings his club up. Rip Kendrick into the lineup, and he's the guy with the ball. Rip Kendrick, the best gain of the night so far, and we are not very far into the football game, but you can already see that that is a powerful young man. Archie Lewis on the stop, and Marcus Williams teaming up for Valdosta.
Rip Kendrick, I tell you, if this guy is healthy enough to play a long time, he will be a factor in this ball game. You can see him as he just rips right through the defense and just knocks Jason Jelks off of him with no sweat at all.
I talked to him after their win over Marietta, their comeback win, and he was hurting so badly, Fred, he could barely stand on the field and talk. Very sore shoulder, and was limited the next week, in fact, against Warner Robins. Bush again, a handoff. This is Ricky Smith. Not as much doing for him on the second down play. They're going to be, I think, a long three. Third and a long three coming out of there. Sebastian Davis and Marcus Williams. And already you've heard that name Williams more than once.
He's having a great game so far.
It is third and three indeed for Clark Central. We'll visit that sideline as soon as we see what the Gladiators do on this particular play as Bush brings him out. He's got two receivers right, but now one in motion to his left. They stick it on the ground. Stacy Bailey, and he has the first down. And almost to midfield, Stacy Bailey picks up the first down of the evening for the Clark Central Gladiators. Joe Washington down on that Clark Central sideline. Joe?
Randy, Fred, I'm with Terry Oswalt, father of Clark Central center Andy Oswalt, and you played against the Valdosta team in 1968. You were with Robert E. Lee.
Robert E. Lee in 1961 for the state championship.
Under Wright Bazemore, has the Wright style Bazemore changed at all?
Quite a bit, Joe. These guys run more like a pro offense. It's amazing.
Well, that's awesome. Thanks a lot. Randy, Fred, back to you.
Thank you, Joe. A lot of tradition here. Not just at Valdosta, but this game in its entirety. And not much going there for the Gladiators. Up the middle, pickup of a couple by Rip Kendrick, who scored 9 times on the ground for Clark Central this year, and he is just a junior, so he'll be back next year. And we're down to 6:45 in the first quarter and scoreless. Most think this will be a low-scoring game.
What Valdosta is doing on defense now, Randy, they're bringing in 3 fresh guys on the down line. And what they'll try to do, Coach Hyder and Charles Tarpon, the defensive coordinator, will try to rotate in, keep some fresh bodies on the defense.
They just keep throwing those numbers at you. People coming off the bench. The pitch out to this side, Ricky Smith, and he is a tough one to bring down. No one's going to get him. Ricky Smith, the first score of the ball game in rather spectacular fashion, takes the pitch to his right, and that is reminiscent of one he had in the quarterfinal against Marietta. Once he gets a step, he is gone, and Nick Hyder's words come into play when he said, "I am scared to death of number 3.
They pull everybody here. Look at this, the old student body right, and they get great blocking from the offensive line and a great cutback by Ricky Smith. And the Anthony Roundtree just could not make that play, and it is 6-0 with the extra point coming.
Matt McNeil to try the extra point for Clark Central, and he's got it. The Gladiators have a 7-point lead over the Valdosta Wildcats here at Valdosta, which is so very, very important for a visiting team coming in here to take this crowd out of the game. We've got 6:12 left in the first quarter. Back after these messages.
This season, Pizza Hut's giving you something to celebrate. The Holiday Stuffer, a pizza loaded with 10 great toppings. Pepperoni, mushrooms and olives, Italian sausage, ham and bacon, beef and pork toppings, onions, even green peppers. Now at Pizza Hut, try one medium for a special price of $9.99. Any second pizza's half its menu price. But you'd better hurry, because when the season ends, so does the deal.
For free delivery, Atlanta's calling 662-5555.
Do you remember that story about the three bears?
This was too big.
That was too small. And finally, something fit just right. Like the J30 from Infiniti. Now that's my definition of luxury. It's a car you just slip right into and live happily ever after.
For a J30 signature lease, see your Infiniti dealer today.
No, 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 no. That's not the M Squad.
No.
That's not the M Squad. No way.
Uh-uh. Try again.
You're kidding, right?
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 This is the M Squad. And this is how you recognize it.
The M Squad by Fila.
Pell South's commitment to the United Negro College Fund is year-round. Hi, I'm Carl Swearingen. We believe in the value of education and put that belief into action. To encourage our employees' involvement, we match every donation 2-for-1. These funds provide students with new learning opportunities, utilizing the latest technology in telecommunications. Programs that once were only a dream have become a reality through Bell South. At Bell South, we join the UNCF in the belief that a mind is a terrible thing to waste.
Valdosta down early 7-0 as Clark Central gets set to kick it off. John Bell back deep. He is flanked by Tommy Speed and Nakia McMullen. Rick Selleck, the man to kick it off for Clark Central. Speed at his 5. To the middle and to some daylight and to the 28-yard line. Joe Washington down on the sideline now.
Yeah, I'm here with Ricky Smith. And, Ricky, you busted through that middle there and got going, shifted into fourth gear. When did it really start feeling good to you?
I think I got past the linebackers. I knew I was going there.
You were cooking, huh?
Yes, sir.
Ricky Smith gets the Gladiators on the scoreboard first. Back to you, Randy and Fred.
Thank you, Joe. He knows about those linebackers, doesn't he, Fred?
Yeah, he does.
All right, Valdosta got the triple set over here, and they go to the quick one to Bell, and he's up over the 31-yard line to about the 32. Jeff Greer, the stop for Clark Central.
Scoring drive, Randy, 5 plays, 65 yards, 2 minutes and 27 seconds, capped off by the Smith 48-yard touchdown run. That time, as we take a look at Nick Heider, they did what's called trips, 3 receivers to one side. They'll do that a lot. Also, in their offset formation, it will appear to be trips, and the defense will treat it that way when it goes to the wide field like it does right now.
All right, catch sticking on the ground again, and they are going to come up shy of the first down, so they will have a third down situation. David Williams, the carry, and Reggie Smith, the stop, the backup nose man in there for Clark Central on the tackle.
I think Steve Everson is still in a kind of a feeling out stage, Randy. I don't think that he doesn't look comfortable out there making reads in particular.
Third and one for Valdosta. We got an equipment repair for Clark Central at the moment. We don't know yet if we'll have to stop the action. Might be able to do it quickly. We saw Nick Heider a moment ago. He's got 218 wins as the coach here, but you know, it hasn't all been easy. He took over in 1974. His first team went 3-7. He suspended 12 full-time players. That did not sit well with this community. But Nick Heider is a man of very strong will. And some 18 seasons after that, they love him. Everson has 2 receivers to his right. But on a third and short, predictably, they stick it on the ground, and it looks like he has enough for the first down.
One thing, Valdosta is not afraid to run into the short side of the field, the boundary. And Everson that time, if you notice, he did, instead of stringing it out, he went ahead and let the fake, let the linebacker bite on the fake and then tuck in right behind him. Good enough for the first down.
Godfrey McWhorter on the stop for Clark Central, but not before Everson had that first down.
Go, go, go!
Everson has Williams and Nakia McMullen in the backfield behind him, and he's going to look to throw this time quickly to Bell. Diving catch. Looks like he has it just shy of the 45.
Valdosta spreads out the defense. It's very difficult to cover each one of those receivers. They'll go with that pro set, and you can see Bell just get right underneath the defensive back, Ben Daniels, and the play is so quick, it's just tough to defend. But I tell you what, if you're Clark Central, you let them do that, because nobody's patient enough to do that kind of stuff all night long.
Chris Rocky is wide right, Bell left, and McMullen in motion for Valdosta. They go up the middle to Williams, and he crosses midfield, has a first down at the 48-yard line of Clark Central. Looked like he coughed it up in there. He did, and Clark Central has the football. Jeff Greer.
David Williams, after an outstanding run, turns the ball over. And this is what we talked about, Randy. We thought that possibly if someone left it on the ground, that it was going to, you know, really turn this game around. And now you've got Clark Central with a chance to strike quickly as Frank Battle, number 91, will make the play and punch it loose. As you can see him punch it right there. Great job by Frank Battle.
Just before that ball was down, it came loose to it. Clark Central looking to strike quickly. Palmer Bush looking for a receiver. Nobody open. And running is not his strength, but he's doing a good job of it here to the far side.
Poor tackling by Valdosta. Nick Hyder cannot be happy about that. Penalty flag on the play.
Troy Brown to stop for the Wildcats. As you said, the yellow flag down. We'll have to see what it is.
As you watch a football game, Randy, most times the offensive guard will take you through the play. And that time, it really did. Ron Smith, who has done a good job pulling so far tonight, was out there on what you call a boot pass, a sprint out pass. And I think it's going to go against Valdosta.
Defensive holding against the Wildcats as Palmer Bush penetrating into Cat territory even deeper.
Now you see the guard, 72, right there, Teron Smith. He pulls, and then Palmer Bush says, hey, it's open, let's go. And he did. And then you can see Valdosta just not wrapping people up. You've got to wrap your arms, and just really poor tackling on the part of Valdosta.
It is relatively quiet here, Fred. And if Billy Henderson's team goes up by another score, it's going to get even quieter. 20th year at Clark Central, 203 wins, 50 losses, and a tie. Billy Henderson played for Wally Butts at Georgia, played in the Sugar, the Cotton, and the Orange Bowls. And the butterflies in the stomach tonight for him, just as great, I'm sure, as they were when he played in those major college bowl games. Clark Central has the first down at the 32-yard line of Valdosta. The officials getting everybody set here. There are some differences in rulings between what you are used to seeing on Saturday afternoon or Saturday night, Sunday afternoon, whatever, between professional and college football and high school football. And as the evening progresses, we will try to get to those for you. They are simply having trouble figuring out where the infraction occurred and where to spot this football at the moment, which gives us an opportunity to tell you who the officials are. The referee is Chip Ferguson. As he comes over to talk to Coach Nick Hyder, Billy Wadsworth, Phil McKinley, Terry Mock, and Billy Beckett is the crew. And when you add those up, they have about 70 years experience officiating high school football. Nonetheless, sometimes there are moments when confusion reigns, as it did just a minute ago. Now we are set to go, and Clark Central has the first and 10 down at the 27-yard line is where the ball has been spotted. And in motion to the right, Palmer faking the pitch and then handing to Kendrick. Crosses the 25.
Quick hitting play that time, the right side of the offensive line for Clark Central. Teron Smith did a great job at the guard play. He got out quickly, led the way for Rip Kendrick in there on that quick hitting play.
Wallace Paul and Brinson Barker combined on the stop for Valdosta, the nose guard and the tackle for the Wildcats defense. So it's second and 8 as Bush brings it up. We're down to about 3.5 minutes in the first quarter. Clark Central leading and driving. Peyton in motion. Kendrick. The big kid down close to the 20.
They'll run that motion, Randy, and they'll set Valdosta up to possibly come back with an option later on.
Antonio Speed on the stop, but not before Kendrick got a chunk.
Great blocking up front by Andy Osbolt. The center completely turned his man out of the play.
Third and four, very big play in this possession for Clark Central. Kendrick Hall is wide left. Bailey and Kendrick in the backfield. Peyton in motion. Kendrick again, a gaping hole. And he's going to make it to the corner. Rip Kendrick, as the Clark Central Gladiators have stunned this crowd here at Cleveland Field in Valdosta with two touchdown runs, 10th of the year on the ground for Rip Kendrick. So first of all, Smith, and then Kendrick scoring on the ground.
Watch again from the end zone camera. Just a straight fullback dive. Just one of the most simplest plays, I'm sure, in the playbook.
Simple but efficient and effective in this case, and the Gladiators trying to make it 14-0. They do so, and the favored Valdosta Wildcats, as Matt McNeil tacked on the extra point. Valdosta had an idea of winning another national championship coming in here. They need to take care of business because Kendrick and the Clark Central Gladiators are rolling. It is 14-0. Clark Central up on top at the moment. And we want to take some time here to recognize some other sports during the course of this football game. As a proud corporate sponsor of Georgia High School Association, AT&T recognizes state champs and other activities in Quad A. This year in softball, Roswell won it. Triple A champion was Ringgold. Double A was Screven County. And the Class A champion was Macon County. Meanwhile, back here in the football game, it is Valdosta's followers, many, many faithful. At the moment, not much to cheer about.
They are stunned, as well they should be.
John Bell is deep, and John Bell will take it. If he touched that line, it's a touchback, but he didn't, so he has a chance to run it out, and he did not get back to the 20-yard line. Good special teams coverage by Clark Central. Brad Blanchard on the stop for the Gladiators.
Four plays, 52 yards, a minute 54. Kendrick with a 21-yard run. The big plays coming from the running backs of Clark Central as they are busting it right up the gut on Valdosta. We'll see what Steve Everson and company have in store for this drive.
They need to, at the very least, Fred, get out of here and get some field position, even if they end up kicking it away. On the ground, Alfred Barnes, the carry for Valdosta, and a little extracurricular activity there, too. Whether the ball is loose or tempers are loose, I am not sure which.
And we talked about Frank Battle. He made that play, and we talked about him as a drop end when he steps back off the line of scrimmage when he is in the short side of the field. That's where he was on that play. So he was off the line of scrimmage, Randy. He was playing as a linebacker, much more free to run to the football. That's how he made that play.
All right, a gain of five, so second and five. Excuse me, second and two. They picked up eight on that play. And up for the first down is Bell on the reception. Takes a couple licks and goes out of bounds, but he's got the first down for Valdosta.
Frank Battle is there again. This guy's playing a whale of a game at the defensive end spot. He's getting into the coverage, and when a defensive end can go out that wide and make a play, he's a player.
Nick Heider, whose club is down 14-0, that he preaches the never, ever, ever give up. And what he says here goes. So you can be sure. You can be sure that Valdosta's not out of this thing, as Tommy Speed had to get a little equipment adjustment there, and we are set to go. First down on the 34-yard line. Valdosta in their own end and in a little bit of trouble. Down to Clark Central, 14-0. Never seen the throw. A pump fake and nobody there.
I'm going to tell you what happened that time, Randy. John Bell, number 8, cut off his route. Everson wanted to go deep. Bell stopped. So you can see Everson's hesitation for a moment. He looked to his left. Bell had cut off the route. Now watch. Everson's going to drop back. Good protection. See that? Nobody there.
He got a yard out of it, so it's 2nd and 9 at the 35. Raw play. Will go for more than a yard, that's for sure, as Speed tries to get to the left sideline and looks to be just, well, he might have the first down. It'll be close.
Even though the passing isn't successful, Randy, it forces the defense to back up off the football, and that opens up plays such as the draw.
Yeah, they're going to call it just shy. I mean barely shy. Have the first down at the moment. And, in fact, they're going to bring in the sticks and take a look at it. It'll be a 2nd down situation, even if they do come up short. But they have to bring the sticks all the way across to take a look at it. First down, Valdosta. Joe Washington down on the sidelines. Joe?
Randy, I'm with Rick Kendrick right now. Rick, got to feel a little different for you guys in a playoff game, and you're not trailing in the first half.
Yeah, we've been down the last few games. We've had to come out, try to get ahead and get them down early.
Well, we got a different attitude in the championship final. Thanks, Rick. Randy, Fred, back to you.
Thank you, Joe. Valdosta sets up with a first down on the 45, and Everson looking to throw again and looking at Bell, who has been his favorite target tonight. Diving catch in Clark Central territory at the 48-yard line.
Ben Daniels obviously showing respect to John Bell. He's 47 in the white jersey playing the cornerback. Locked up out there on John Bell, playing about 6 yards off the football. Is afraid to get beat deep. But again, that's really a good play because the underneath stuff won't happen all night long.
Under 30 seconds. In fact, approaching 10 seconds left in the first quarter as Alfred Barnes, the carry there for Valdosta. Looks like that'll be the last play of our first quarter with the Wildcats in control when we come back for the second quarter of play. But frankly, in a little bit of trouble because Clark Central has come in here and taken control. They lead by a score of 14-0. We'll be back after these messages from your local stations.
This season, Pizza Hut's giving you something to celebrate. The Holiday Stuffer, a pizza loaded with 10 great toppings. Pepperoni, mushrooms and olives, Italian sausage, ham and bacon, beef and pork toppings, onions, even green peppers. Now at Pizza Hut, try one medium for a special price of $9.99. Any second pizza's half its menu price. But you'd better hurry, because when the season ends, so does the deal.
For free delivery, Atlanta's calling 662-5555.
If you have a child, you need a family escape plan to get out before fire gets you. A holiday message from Eggleston, the Children's Hospital at Emory University. If you have a child, get him a helmet, so even if he hits the ground, his head won't. A holiday message from Eggleston, the Children's Hospital at Emory University.
Tell him what it is.
1992, Behind the Hedges.
We gotta have it. Good job.
Giving you a rare look at a side of Georgia football you never see.
And he's just like Jones in that camera line up too deep.
From the strategy to the sidelines.
We got man-to-man every time, every single time.
Hastings caught it. Touchdown.
UGA, the 100-year season of Bulldog football. December 30th at 10 p.m. on 11 Alive.
They say it's all new.
Brand spanking new.
They say it's a bigger challenge.
Good thing I've got all the answers.
Well, for once, they're right.
They? Who's that?
You!
Oh, yeah, right. I could have told you that.
So aim for the fun and play the bullseye round.
Take your best shot.
On the new Family Feud.
Family Feud, weeknights at 7:30 on 11 Alive.
Our game summary brought to you by Pizza Hut. Hotlanta's calling Pizza Hut, and Fred Clark Central has called on their ground game, 105 yards rushing to this point.
That's a big-time stat in the first quarter to pile up 105 yards rushing on a defense like Valdosta. That is really, really big-time. Total yards for Valdosta, 62, 44 on the ground, 18 through the air. Look at this last play. It's a tackle trap. Chris Gingro, number 67, will pull. So he's the tackle. That's the tackle trap. They close down. Clark Central closes down on the play, and number 7, Kevin Johnson, does a great job to smell the trap and come up and stuff it. Johnson McWhorter made a great play closing down on the tackle he was pulling.
Back live now, Valdosta, 3rd and 2, and Everson fakes it and keeps it, and he's got the first down and a little bit more, getting down to the 42-yard line of Clark Central. Greer coming up to make the stop. Jeff Greer for Clark Central.
Now, Steve Everson is going to go out wider than normal. We talked about the wide veer. You can see how he takes it out even a little bit wider, gets everybody to bite on the fake, read it perfectly, held that ball to the last possible second, and then pulled it back.
A rather complicated scenario, but a simple explanation is most teams don't run the wide veer. Most of them run it inside, so defenses aren't used to seeing it, and they go to the air this time. The pass is complete. Alfred Barnes on the reception. Jeff Greer, the coverage for Clark Central.
Quick look-in pattern. Jeff Greer is going to, or Alfred Barnes is going to be open on that play almost every time on the quick look-in until Clark Central steps up and plays him a little bit tighter. Watch. Just simple. Bam. 1 second. He's right there. Wide open. Twins to the wide side of the field. That's two receivers. Twins out there to the left.
Pickup of 9, so it's 2nd and 1 on the 32, and they'll take a look and see whether it was under 10 and called 9. It is just barely under 10 yards, and so it will be 2nd and officially 1, but actually it's just a few inches to go, as you can see, for the first down for Valdosta.
This would be a great time. 2nd and 1, always a good time to go ahead and go deep.
Well, they've got the kid who can do it, Everson, that is for sure. And they've got the speed outside to do it, but you can bet that Clark Central and Billy Henderson well aware of that situation. All right, we're ready to go. 2nd and very, very short for Valdosta on the Clark Central 32. 3 receivers to the right. And that's where he goes. And it's behind Barnes and incomplete.
You know, they went what we call trips to the one side of the field, to the right side of the field, excuse me, and then you can see that Alfred Barnes could not make that play. Throw a little bit behind him, though.
He would have had the first down, but as we said, it was a very, very short, 2nd and short. It now becomes 3rd and short. And Valdosta doing some shuffling along the line of scrimmage as they set up for this one. Early 2nd quarter as they go for the first down and get it inside the 30. Tommy Speed, the carry, and Anton Goldwire, the tackle.
Good read that time from Steve Everson. Watch the charge from the offensive line. Last second, great play. Held it in there. Everson held it in there and then ended up giving it to Speed at the very last second. That was a good read on the Godfrey McWhorter, who was coming up to make the play.
Chris Rocky to the right, Bell to the left, and man in motion Barnes for Valdosta. Everson looking to his right, and then back over the middle and left, and Bell is the man with the football down to the 15-yard line.
One-on-one coverage with Ben Daniels. That's what Valdosta wants. When they put the man in motion, it put 3 receivers to the right side. The tight end, the flanker, and the back. Ben Everson looks back, wide open, John Bell. Daniels does make the play, but it's good enough for a first down. Look from the end zone. You can see that he's all by himself over there because the defense has to honor that motion and the 3 receivers to the right side of the field.
There you see him, John Bell. He's a senior. And as you can tell, he's a good one. This time, Everson, 2 receivers right, and he's coming this way. And looking. And overthrowing in the end zone.
Good pressure that time by Kevin Johnson, number 7, the linebacker, who really, really came and put pressure on Everson. And I think really forced him to overthrow Bell.
And Eric Hurd down there with the coverage. A little bit to do with that as well. So it is a second down play now for Valdosta.
You know, the tight end has not been involved yet in a pass play, and of course he caught the winning, or the only touchdown pass, Shedrick Green, last week.
Second and 10 on the 15. Again to throw. Everson trying to find a hole and got back to the line of scrimmage. Frank Battle. A very familiar name by now.
Number 91. Making some plays.
Nick Hyder looking on from the sideline. We had a chance to visit with him a little bit yesterday. Tell you more about that later. You see Frank Battle, the guy who's visiting that Valdosta offensive backfield quite a bit. A third down play, and they run the draw. Speed trying to get outside, and he is shut down over there by the Clark Central defense. Ben Daniels and Reggie Lewis combining on the stop.
Great play by the defensive secondary to see the draw come up and stuff it.
Well, he barely got back to the line of scrimmage, so it's fourth down and just a hair under 10 for Valdosta, so they will try the field goal. Ryan Sanderson, and if the last name sounds familiar, Ryan Sanderson to try this field goal. Alan Sanderson did the kicking off, and they are twins. Ryan wearing number 10, Alan wears number 18. And Alan does the kicking off and the long distance chores. They feel Ryan is the more accurate of the two, and the ball is down at just outside the 21, so it's a 31-yard field goal attempt. If you think those goalposts look a little wider than college football, you are right. They're almost 6 feet wider. That kick has no chance. It was low and to the left, as some good penetration there by the Clark Central defense. So Valdosta's first chance to get on the scoreboard is turned away by Clark Central.
Joey Hall made a great play that time. Good pressure from the outside. He's a backup linebacker in on the special teams and really put the heat on.
Well, special teams helped do it for Clark Central in their semifinal win as they blocked the punt against Warner Robins. And that was a key factor in the overtime win by the penetration rule for the Gladiators. They take over first and 10 on their own 20. Palmer Bush in the eye, now the man in motion. Big play on the ground, and Kendrick is nailed.
Big time stunt, Randy, a big time stunt that time. Marcus Williams was coming all the way. He did not make the play, but the backside, James Robinson, number 98, made the play. Look at that. There's the, you see him going right in. He goes unblocked because they were pulling the guard trying to trap. So when Teron Smith got out of there on the trap, then it was Valdosta making the play. Look at that. First team defense has allowed only 4 touchdowns.
And we heard some talk here, Fred. They're so concerned. This team has given up 13 points in the playoffs. That tells you what kind of success they are used to. It is second and 12 for Clark Central as they try to go wide to the left side and up across the 23 to the 24-yard line is Ricky Smith, the man who broke the long gainer for the first touchdown of the night. Franklin Wiseman, the defensive end, the tackle for Valdosta.
Valdosta went with the 7-man front that time, really put everybody up on the line of scrimmage. And if Clark Central continues to run the way they are, look for more men on the line of scrimmages. Valdosta just throws, 8-9-man front.
And he told us, the defensive coordinator for Valdosta told us yesterday, he said, if they run it and run it and run it, I'll bring 7, 8, 9. I might just keep bringing it. Third and 7 as Palmer Bush is in a tough situation here in his own territory. Fumble on the play. Valdosta says they have it, but we'll have to unstack them first, and they do indeed recover the football at the 31-yard line of Clark Central.
Big play by Marcus Williams, who comes out of there with the fumble recovery. Marcus Williams really absorbed a big-time block, but the ball just bounced in his favor. Weston Webb drilled him. Look at him. Took him completely out of the play. And Kendrick fumbles the football right to Marcus Williams.
He ran into Andy Osbold, his own man, and Valdosta got the football. We'll be back with the score, 14-0 Clark Central, back after these messages.
Just because the 80s are over doesn't mean you have to stop looking out for number one, especially when Chevrolet makes it so easy for you. For instance, for a limited time, Chevrolet has made it possible for dealers to get you a new Lumina equipped with the extras you're looking for, but without the extra cost. Now, who said the 90s were going to be dull? The sure thing is going on now. See your participating Chevrolet dealer.
McDonald's Holiday Film Festival, now featuring the American epic Dances with Wolves. The original full-length video, unbelievably priced at just $7.99 when you buy any large sandwich. So hurry in and pick up Dances with Wolves. Also available, the family favorite, Babes in Toyland, and the hilarious Dirty Rotten Scoundrels. These films just $5.99 each when you buy any large sandwich. What you want is what you get at McDonald's today.
Bell South's commitment to the United Negro College Fund is year-round. Hi, I'm Carl Swearingen. We believe in the value of education and put that belief into action. To encourage our employees' involvement, we match every donation 2-for-1. These funds provide students with new learning opportunities, utilizing the latest technology in telecommunications. Programs that once were only a dream have become a reality through Bell South. At Bell South, we join the UNCF in the belief that a mind is a terrible thing to waste.
Randy Waters, Fred Khalil, and Joe Washington back with you live from Cleveland Field in Valdosta, where Clark Central leads 14-0, just under 8 minutes, second quarter. But Valdosta has just recovered the fumble. Each has a turnover, and Valdosta trying to cash in right now. The quick hitter, not much going there, inside the 25, and a flag down on the play. Nakia McMullen, the reception. Mike Daniels, the coverage for Clark Central.
Made a great play. Might have been on a little bit of the face mask out there.
It is unavoidable at times.
On a play like that, when there's just two guys locked out of there, that really, any way you can bring it down as we look at it, you can see 55, Mike Daniels coming around with that right hand, just barely. He got off it in time, an inadvertent face mask. It'll still take the ball down to the 12-yard line, first and 10 for Valdosta.
They come out trailing, although Steve Everson, only 2 incompletions on the evening. So they've been effective through the air as far as completion percentage. Nothing big for them yet, but they're hoping things will loosen up, I'm sure. The single back and 3 receivers, and he is looking into the direction of all of them, and he finds McMullen down around the 10-yard line.
Anton Goldwire making the play out there from his linebacker spot. They're going to have to bring, you know, when the linebackers have to cover the fast guys like that, the underneath stuff will be open. But because the pressure Clark Central's put on from the backside, Shadrick Green, the tight end, has had to stay in and block. He has not been involved in the passing game yet tonight.
They get 3 on the play, so they're down around the 9, just inside the 10, and it's 2nd and 7. Tim White is the receiver who is wide left for Valdosta. Officials timeout here for an equipment adjustment. We've had a couple of those tonight. These officials make sure all these kids are ready to go so no accidents occur in the heat of the competition. Everson to throw. Now scrambling. Now heading for the end zone. Now in for the touchdown. Very close, but he made it.
Steve Everson made that play happen by himself. We talked about Shedrick Green getting involved in the passing offense. If you look at it, that's who he wanted. He wanted Shadrick Green, and Green was open momentarily, but he had to pull it out and tuck it. Now watch, Everson's back to pass. Right there, Shadrick Green was open, tucked it underneath, and put it in the end zone for the score.
His 12th rushing touchdown of the season makes it 14-6, and they'll try to make it 14-7. Ryan Sanderson sticks it through the middle, so Valdosta has cut it down to a one-touchdown difference. 14-7 as Clark Central still up, but now by only one score. And again, as a proud corporate sponsor of the Georgia High School Association, AT&T is pleased to recognize state champions crowned in other activities other than football this year. Here's our list of champs in boys cross country. Quad A, it was South Gwinnett, Triple A, Westminster, Double A, Lovett, and in Class A, it was Pace Academy. Fred, that's one thing you and I have in common. We are not built for cross country. Those kids go forever.
No doubt about that.
All right, Nick Kider has to be feeling a little bit better about his situation right now.
They're right back in this ball game.
6:42 to go, second quarter, 14-7 Clark Central. Kendrick Hall and Eric Herr back for Clark Central as Allen Sanderson. Low liner bounces at about the 27, and Clark Central some indecision, and that one's dead on the 10.
Really miscommunication that time between Kendrick Hall and Eric Herr.
Well, there's Hall.
Now, see, he left it for Herr. You got to pick up the ball and go. Buddy did the smart thing instead of trying to scoop it up and maybe, you know, dropping the football. He fell on it. It's poor field position for Clark Central, but no turnover.
Went off of his foot. And now this crowd, and I'm sure this Valdosta defense, feels like they really got something going as Palmer Bush brings him out in the pro set. They keep it on the ground. Kendrick fighting along the line of scrimmage. And that was all east-west, as they like to say. There was nothing doing north-south. Kevner Dyer, the stop for Valdosta.
Let's watch Dyer. He is the nose tackle, plays off the block. And really, that's a good block. If the guy goes around you, the backside from the play, he certainly is not expected to make the play. But Dyer, he's got that speed, doesn't quit, makes the tackle from the backside by going all the way around the block.
They get nothing out of it. It is second and 10. Now to the left side, and again, big, big trouble for Stacy Bailey. Inside the 5-yard line, James Robinson nails it.
Randy, this is the quote-unquote number two TNT in the ball game for Valdosta. Tackle, nose, and tackle. And look at that. Untouched. James Robinson. Big time play. Watch it again. It's number 98. Comes right in and makes the play. Good open field tackle by Robinson. And now it's third and a mile.
At the 5-minute mark, Clark Central leading 14-7, but third and 18 on their own 3-yard line. Nothing fancy here. Nothing doing either. Rip Kendrick, the ball carrier.
6-1 look that time. Six-man front for Valdosta. The man in the middle, Marcus Williams, came over the top and almost grabbed Bush before he could hand off the football. Clark Central playing it safe. You do not want to turn the ball over or make a pass play or some play that you really are not sure of down in that territory.
John Bell standing inside the Clark Central 40-yard line awaiting the punt from Eric Herr. And Clark Central, evidently when they line up for that, did not like something they saw in the Valdosta defensive formation, because the Gladiators, rather than go ahead and run the play, rather than risk Valdosta getting a big one down here, a block, call timeout.
They only had 10 guys on the field, I think.
Well, Clark Central called the timeout.
Yeah, Charles Tarpley is the defensive coordinator. He spent some time with us yesterday, really explaining defense to us and what he was going to try to do. And he does a great job here.
Coleman Rudolph's father, the Georgia Tech all-time sack leader, Coleman, his father used to be defensive coordinator here for many years, 15-plus years, and that gives you an idea where Nick Heider places his priorities. He gave Coleman's father the option of stepping down from that if he wanted to, and he now coaches the ninth grade so he can travel, or so he could travel on Friday and watch Coleman play at Georgia Tech. All right, back to the action now, and a 4th and 17, and Hurd back up against very, very deep in his own end zone, right back on the line. He cannot afford a half step back. Gets it away cleanly, fairly long at the 44-yard line. Here's Bell trying to find room to the right. Not much, but he is down to about the 35-yard line. So, with Clark Central having a 14-0 lead, and a hit made by Bill Carter, and we'll be back after these words from your local stations.
How much?
Ah, Pulsar?
Pulsar?
Pulsar Poreste.
I think he wants your watch.
But honey, you gave me this watch.
Money. How much money?
Ah, Pulsar también?
Si, Pulsar.
Pulsar Poreste.
What, is he kidding?
No.
Some things in life are worth far more than they cost.
No thank you.
Pulsar. There's no time like it.
It's Christmas at Home Depot, and our garden center is filled with truckloads of freshly cut, premium quality Christmas trees. And best of all, the prices are low Home Depot prices. You'll also save money on festive poinsettia plants. There are hundreds to choose from, and Home Depot's prices are guaranteed. And remember, if you can't decide what to give someone on your list, a Home Depot gift certificate is the most practical gift of all. Happy holidays from Home Depot, where low prices are just the beginning.
The Lexus Coupe can be equipped with a cellular phone that allows you to dial, answer, and hang up without ever letting go of the wheel. Proving once you get your hands on a Lexus, they tend to stay that way.
This fall, only one Atlanta TV station gives you all the action and excitement of athletic competition. 11 Alive, bringing you the tradition of ACC football and basketball.
And here comes Forrest at the buzzer.
The spirit of high school athletics with state championship events brought to you live. A team specializing in complete local sports coverage.
An interception for Ken Swilling.
This fall, the action is on 11 Alive.
Randy Waters, Fred Kalil, and Joe Washington back with you live from Cleveland Field in Valdosta, where the homestanding Tigers trail 14-7, but they have the football on the Clark Central 34-yard line. Steven Everson, the quarterback, is going to keep and look to throw, and he wants to go deep. Had two receivers down there, but good coverage. Nakia McMullen and John Bell both down there inside the 5-yard line.
Excellent coverage that time by Clark Central. But look at this. Valdosta now with more total yards, 109 to 103.
Well, they'll come up 2nd and 10, still on the 34-yard line. Again to throw. Batted down at the line of scrimmage. Mike Daniels got a piece of it. Let's go down to Joe Washington on the sideline.
Well, an obvious momentum shift here in favor of Valdosta. Got a Valdosta fan here, Terry Wallheiser. Sorry about that.
That's okay.
Well, I tell you what, this thing turns out close in the end. Can the crowd be a factor?
Crowd can be. When it gets a little tough, we stand behind them, though.
Let's see that sign, huh? Let's see what you got. Throw it up there. All right, these paws were made for walking all the way to state. Okay, well, we'll see. Fred, Randy, back to you.
They need to walk 10 yards to get a first down here from the 34, and Everson has time, and he has a receiver, but it is dropped by Tim White at the 25-yard line. He would have been a little bit short of the first down had he been able to hold on to it.
Everson very, very unhappy about that. He felt that the catch should have been made. He's getting lots of time. Everson's getting lots of time to throw. You know, that offensive line, Gingro, Holt, Grant, Hunter, Harrison, really doing a great job.
Well, Valdosta with a 4th and 10 calls the timeout as Nick Hyder heads out to the field to talk things over here. And, well, as I mentioned before, when he speaks, boy, it'll be quiet in that huddle. I'll guarantee you that. I want to remind you that in a few days, Wednesday, December 30th, 11 Alive brings you a side of Georgia football you never see, a rare look at the Bulldogs in the locker room and on the sidelines. UGA, the 100-year season of Bulldog football. That's December 30th, 10 p.m. on 11 Alive. And, Fred, you are getting ready to head for the Citrus Bowl.
The Citrus Bowl as Georgia plays Ohio State. It's going to be an excellent ball game down there.
Let's take a look and see how the Clark Central Gladiators got here. They defeated Parkview by 4, then a little easier time of it against Alexander. The two stirring comebacks were against Marietta and Warner Robins. The Marietta win, 26-22, and in overtime against Warner Robins by the penetration rule. Now, Valdosta, one less game because they got the first round bye, beat Griffin 18-6, Northside Warner Robins by 10, 17-7, then shut out Dunwoody. Dunwoody came down here and gave a very good account of themselves, but came up short 10-0. Now, 4th and 10 for Valdosta, and they are going to go for it here from the 34. A man open. Bell reached behind him and made a nice catch down at the 21.
Good protection that time by Everson by the offensive line again. And when he sprints out, he stretches that defense and something is open. You can see Bell look right in there and make the catch.
You know, Fred, I have to admit something to you as we watch this replay. When we talked about that Georgia special on December 30th, I thought, no, we're not that late into December. It's sneaking up on us, isn't it?
No, we're talking about Christmas next
Friday. That's right. First down, Everson. Nobody open to his right, and here he goes. Inside the 10. Anton Goldwire finally caught it.
The guy makes plays. There's no doubt about that. That dimension back there, it's kind of a Sean Jones type dimension for folks who watch Georgia Tech play. When he gets back there, if nothing's going, he is.
He wastes no time either. He has a first down for his Valdosta team, his Cats, at the 8-yard line, a first and goal. They stay on the ground and nothing doing there for Tommy Speed.
Simple dive play that time. Valdosta going with just two backs lined up closer together than usual right behind Everson.
He's got two receivers right. Bell, who's been his favorite target, and Robert Randolph. And here he comes to the right, looking to throw, but instead keeping it and getting just inside the 5.
You hear talk of the triple option. You know, what are the 3? Obviously, you hand, keep, pitch. This time, he could have done that or throw the ball. He was looking to throw, but he tucked it up and went under again. When that guy gets outside, when he breaks contain, when Everson does that, it really puts the defense at a disadvantage.
3rd and goal now. Rocky and Bell to the left. McMullen in Speed behind Everson, who wants to throw. And now he's going to keep it. And now he's going to be stopped at the line of scrimmage, and it'll be 4th down.
Tommy Speed saved a big loss because Kevin Johnson was coming on the blitz. Tommy Speed picked him up and really saved a big loss because Kevin Johnson was coming untouched looking for Steve Everson.
Now they'll bring in Ryan Sanderson and try to get 3 up there and come within 4 points of Clark Central. A minute 40 to go, 2nd quarter. It's 14-7 Gladiators, and Sanderson will try to stick the field goal through. There's Tommy Speed.
Now watch Tommy's speed. He's number 21. You can see the fake. See that? He saw that linebacker coming and stepped up and really made the block. Now, I know that Everson didn't get a gain out of it, but he would have been backed up on the 10-yard line had Tommy Speed not saw that coming and step up and make the block.
Valdosta during the timeout here will gather their forces, as will Clark Central. We mentioned the Wildcats coach Nick Heider a while ago. Yesterday in his office, we were talking with him about his philosophy and how he's been able to get things done here. First, before we talk about Nick, I want to remind you to set that VCR, record the best in this year's holiday programming. 11:35, the Bob Hope four-star Christmas fiesta, followed by an all-new Seinfeld and Christmas in Washington. That's tomorrow night beginning at 11:35. And back to Nick Heider now. Yesterday in his office, Fred, he says, here's my favorite book. The Bible was sitting on his desk. And he says, that is how I operate here. And nobody argues with him. Ryan Sanderson, the field goal attempt. And he sticks it through. And so we now have a 14-10 ball game with a minute 36 to go here in the second quarter. Valdosta down 14-0, has now scored 10 unanswered points to climb right back in this thing. There's the man who just got the three, Ryan Sanderson. And again, that's his eighth field goal of the season. His twin brother, Alan Sanderson, number 18, does the kicking off. So Ryan goes back and accepts the congratulations for the three. Brother will be out there to kick off here as Clark Central will get the football back with under 2 minutes to go in the first half.
You know, Coach Tarpley was telling us yesterday as they walked by, you know, he just looked at me and said, wish they were juniors, because they're both going to be gone, both two outstanding kids.
Kendrick Hall and Eric Hurd, who had the mix-up the last time that put Clark Central in some bad field position, are back to take the kick, and this one is on the ground. And a nice job at the 35-yard line for Clark Central, as that could have been disastrous. That was like an onside kick, and frankly, Fred, I don't know if he meant it to be or not.
Well, late in the half, I think they wanted to avoid a big return.
Right.
And they've got confidence in their defense, Valdosta does. And they feel like if they get the ball on the 35-yard line, they'll be able to hold them. We'll see.
One little bounce there, and it could have been real interesting. That thing was a rocket. But Clark Central has it, first and 10 on their own 35. Palmer Bush with three backs behind him, and up the middle, and up into some deep, deep trouble goes Ricky Smith. Sebastian Davis to stop for Valdosta.
Great pursuit that time, really. Great pursuit from the Valdosta defense as Palmer Bush is really not throwing the football. 0 for 1.
Well, and as you mentioned, Valdosta will just keep sticking those defensive people up there until Clark Central gives them a reason to loosen up. And so far, they have not given them that reason as Palmer Bush says, hurry up, get in here. We got to get this play off.
You know, DeAnthony Roundtree was in on that play as well. He's the cornerback. He came up and applied pressure, and he can play right almost on the line of scrimmage. You can see him sneak up there now.
Again, Clark Central with 36 seconds in the clock moving. Lavalas Paul stops Stacy Bailey. They are hoping to get out of here with a four-point lead. And Valdosta hoping to get the football back. So the Wildcats call timeout. Billy Henderson, his club, will have a third down and about 7 yards if they are going to avoid having to kick it away. 26 seconds and a half. Clark Central came out here, stunned Valdosta's players, crowd, you name it, this whole community. Ricky Smith, a 46-yard touchdown run. Rip Kendrick, a 21-yard run, and all of a sudden it was 14-0. But Clark Central, on a 10-game winning streak that's enabled them to get here to this state championship game, has given up 10 unanswered points to Valdosta as the Cats have scored the touchdown by Everson on a 12-yard run and a field goal to come within 14-10.
Don't forget, every Saturday night at 7, we bring you a fast-paced half hour of highlights, previews, and special guests from amateur athletics to the big leagues. It's more than just the scores. It's Saturday Sports Live every Saturday night at 7 o'clock here on 11 Alive.
Third and 7 at the 38. And everybody in tight for the Gladiators. And Palmer Bush still has it. Well, he ate up some time, and he nearly did more than that. He nearly got the first down.
I'll tell you what, there was a seven-man front. A seven-man front. Everybody bit on the fake. And Palmer Bush went to the outside and made it very, very close to the first down marker, but he didn't quite. The clock's going to run out, Randy.
And I think he got a little too close to that sideline, frankly, because if he had been knocked out of bounds, then the clock would have stopped, and Valdosta would have been in position to perhaps pounce on it or at least make Clark Central run another play. Here is Joe Washington down on the field with Billy Henderson.
Yeah, I'm with a guy wearing a smile. I'll tell you what, you're looking pretty good in the first half, but you got to be concerned about the momentum
at
this point.
I'm smiling because I like you, Joe. We spent some time last week together, and I like you, and I like your attitude. But yeah, we had a good first quarter. They've got a good second quarter. We've got the crowd in it now, and that's not good for us. But I was glad our youngsters calm down. That's what they've got to do.
And the third quarter's always been pretty good for this Valdosta defense.
That's exactly right. It's a whale of a football game, high school football at its best.
Okay, we'll see you back out there in the second half. Good luck to you, Coach. Fred, Randy, back up to you.
All right, Joe, thanks very much. Joe Washington with Billy Henderson, the coach of Clark Central. His Gladiators on top of Valdosta, 14-10. We're back live from Cleveland Field after this.
No, 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 no. That's not the M Squad.
No.
That's not the M Squad. No way.
Try again.
You're kidding, right?
Right?
Right? This is the M Squad. And this is how you recognize it. The M Squad by Philo.
Ladies and gentlemen, feast your eyes on the elegant J30. A classic luxury sedan in an infinity kind of way. A driver's car with two airbags, soft leather appointments, and tasty wood. Hey, pal, don't you even think about it.
For a J30 signature lease, see your infinity dealer today.
This season, Pizza Hut's giving you something to celebrate. The Holiday Stuffer, a pizza loaded with 10 great toppings. Pepperoni, mushrooms and olives, Italian sausage, ham and bacon, beef and pork toppings, onions, even green peppers. Now at Pizza Hut, try one medium for a special price of $9.99. Any second pizza's half its menu price. But you'd better hurry, because when the season ends, so does the deal.
For free delivery, Atlanta's calling 662-5555.
Milk. You know milk's good for you. Drinking milk helps build strong bones and teeth. But did you know that the latest government research shows that the calcium in milk helps prevent certain types of cancer? And calcium combined with magnesium and potassium, all found in milk, can lower blood pressure. Or that milk is rich in vitamins and minerals needed for healthy skin and eyes. And protein to build muscle tone. Drink milk for health. Drink milk for life. A message from the Georgia Dairy Farmers.
To 10 right now, the score. It is Clark Central on top of Valdosta. Fred Kalil along with Randy Waters, Joe Washington down on the field. And Randy, I tell you what, Clark Central really came out and popped it to right, Valdosta.
Well, I think everybody here in Valdosta was saying, oh boy, we got him at home. And they were looking to get that quick start and maybe have an early celebration here at Cleveland Field. But Billy Henderson and his Clark Central Gladiators certainly had other ideas.
You know, and Clark Central did it with just straight ahead good football. We talked about their power, trying to run it inside, and that's what they did. They did some very good things, very good fundamental things on offense, and led to two touchdowns, two very good runs, and that made it 14-0. And then, of course, Valdosta came back and scored 10 unanswered points, and that's where we are right now.
Well, let's go down to the field now. Joe Washington standing by on the sideline.
I tell you what, guys, I really don't think Billy Henderson was smiling because he was glad to see me. I think he's really happy with the way his Gladiators are playing for the most part. I mean, after all, they were not favored in this ball game. Well, the Georgia High School Association oversees events like football, basketball, track, debate, one-act plays. Bet you didn't know that, did you? Let's take more of a look at that organization.
Defense!
15 sports and several literary events. The Georgia High School Association oversees that and more. To get to the heart of this 99-year-old organization, you travel about an hour and a half south of Atlanta to Thomaston, where the GHSA has been headquartered since the mid-1940s. The offices were originally housed in a laundromat. Sam Burke was executive director, the first of three executive directors Ann Story has worked for.
It has changed an awful lot. When we first started and I worked for Mr. Sam Burke, we had just a few sports, and now we've taken on a lot of different things like soccer for both boys and girls, cheerleading, wrestling, swimming has doubled, and our tennis has probably tripled.
She's part of a staff of five now administering high school extracurricular activities in Georgia, along with administrative assistant Joyce Kay, registrar Brenda Wright, new commissioner of officials Ralph Swearingen, and executive director Tommy Gillibo. A combined 70 years experience is represented on the High School Association staff. Gillibo sees an expanding role for his organization because of the 96 Olympic Games.
The Georgia High School Association is going to have to grow. The activities that are offered in the Olympics certainly will receive some emphasis down at the high school level. I'm sure we'll see something on swimming. I think it'll be a bigger sport. I think soccer will be a bigger sport.
This is the first year of varsity status for volleyball, and cheerleading will stage its first championship in 1994. The GHSA took a major step this fall by appointing two women to the executive committee. Cedar Grove principal Marianne Schreckengost and LaGrange athletic director Lois Myers are a positive sign for girls' athletics in Georgia.
I think that by showing the public that we're there and we're going to support females, that maybe more people should come to their games, market them so that the public becomes aware that there's some good athletes out there and we need to be out there watching them.
We just hope that the local people will get out and support their local schools and student activities and get involved with your local school. That's the way you make great schools, is to get great involvement.
I tell you what, a group of folks who really do get involved and make things happen for these schools are the members of the Booster Club. Butch Bush is president of the Clark Central Touchdown Club, incidentally, Palmer Bush's father. And you got to be happy with the way things are going here. First, I want to talk to you about the fan support you got here. You guys brought down, what, 10 busloads of folks?
At least 10, Joe. We had, at last count, about 2,000 people that came down either on school buses or on Greyhounds or in private cars.
Yeah, as we're going to show people here in a little bit, sometimes it's a little hard to get those folks in Athens excited about the Clark Central program because you got to compete with Georgia.
Well, Athens is a very diverse city. It has a lot of interest, and it's really hard, especially during the season when you play some teams that are not quite the caliber of Valdosta. But when we got into the playoffs, we filled that stadium up in Athens. We were real proud of it.
Yeah, you sure did. Okay, Butch, good luck. Thanks a lot. Okay, we'll be back with more of the Halftime Report right after this.
At Upson's store-wide Christmas sale. 25 to 60% off great gifts for all your friends and family. Oh, what fun it is to save 25 to 60% at Upson's Christmas sale, and then finally you'll have it all wrapped up.
Upton's, just what you're looking for.
What happens when something hot meets something cool?
Hot eats, cool treats, and Dairy Queen.
The full meal deal is going full blast for just $2.49. Get a big, juicy burger, hot fries, soft drink, and delicious 5-ounce sundae. The full meal deal, best bargain in town, yours for just $2.49.
Hot eats, cool treats, we treat you right.
The 14th annual Toyota-thon year-end challenge is going strong.
So now's the best time to buy one of Car and Driver's 10 best, Camry.
With an easy drive lease payment of only $279 a month. That's a new Camry with driver's side airbag for just $279 a month for 36 months. Great.
That is great, but meet Daphne Gill. She wasn't even thinking about buying a car.
No, but the deal was so good, I had to take it.
Incredible. In every region, the challenge is on, and Toyota-thon buyers are winning.
Get to your Toyota dealer now.
Tell them what it is. Be a
bulldog. 1992, Behind the Hedges.
We gotta have it. Good job.
stop.
Giving you a rare look at a side of Georgia football you never see.
Hey, look at Mike Jones and our camera lined up too deep.
From the strategy to the sidelines.
We got man-to-man every time, every single time.
Hastings caught it. Touchdown!
UGA, the 100-year season of Bulldog football. December 30th at 10 p.m. on 11 Alive.
Here we are at halftime with Clark Central leading Valdosta 14-10. Our halftime report is brought to you by the Georgia Dairy Farmers. And now let's go back down to Joe Washington on the sideline. Joe?
Yeah, Randy, we were talking to Butch Bush and how hard it is sometimes for the Clark Central Gladiators to get the people of Athens behind them because they have to compete with Georgia. Well, you know, once the playoffs are here, the folks are behind them solidly. And one guy who really helps make that happen is Billy Henderson.
Summing up the success of Clark Central's football program is pretty simple. The folks around Athens point to one man.
You hear a lot of boys who played for him in 74 and 75, and you'll see him at a game and they'll say, I played for Coach Henderson. They're proud of that. Some people, they don't say I played for Clark Central, I played for Coach Henderson.
Billy Henderson is a Georgia Bulldog who returned to Athens nearly 20 years ago after a successful stint at what was Willingham High, now Southwest Macon.
He was such an outstanding coach against us that I told Don Height that's who I would go interview, and that's what Don Height did. They brought him up and interviewed him the next week.
And the rest, as they say, is history. Three state championships, 18 consecutive trips to the state playoffs. But it's his 1975 team that brings back the fondest memories.
But 1975 was very special because we were 0-4 the first four games. And somehow or another, these youngsters rededicated themselves and won six straight in the sub-regions and really set the standard of excellence that's been enjoyed at Clark Central for so many years.
If 1975 set the standard, then 1977 was the payoff year, the first state title. Charles Campbell was on the team that beat Valdosta.
I sacked Buffalo in the end zone for the safety, and we won 16-14. And being that this, they playing Valdosta now, you know, it brings back them memories, you know, and it feels good.
There's plenty of history here. Clark Central is the former Athens High, where it all started for athletes like Fran Tarkenton and Andy Johnson, who went on to Georgia and the pros. That's like ancient history to these youngsters. Some of them can't think about anything but the present.
The football team gives us strength, you know, as far as, I mean, I guess it makes everyone have a positive attitude. Most people look up to the football team, and I think they also help people strive harder.
I mean, that's all everybody's talking about. You go all around the school, everybody's talking about the football team and going to Valdosta and talking about especially last Saturday's game.
The Gladiators surprised a lot of folks by making it to the championship game. Despite their winning tradition, the community's been slow to show its enthusiasm.
Now, unlike Valdosta, which can put 6,000 fans in the seats on a bad night, Clark Central sometimes has to overcome some obstacles in getting community support. Earlier this year, it was a slow start. One game, only 500 people showed up. The other obstacle is between the hedges. Getting people to divide their loyalties between a successful college program and a perennial high school powerhouse is tough.
We understand the nature of the Athens community. As we approach the playoffs, they really get interested in support the team in the stands, but throughout the year they support us financially, which is very important to
them.
They support Billy Henderson and his kids because of what Henderson brings to the table. He cares.
He said, well, I got a problem. I got one kid that's got nowhere to stay, and I've got to, you know, find him a home. And Billy and his wife Fosky took that young man into their home and kept him for quite a number of weeks.
If it were just the game itself and the score, it wouldn't be enough. But day by day, you get involved in these young lives, and it becomes a drama. I learned a lot of things from Coach Wright Baseball. I've learned a lot of things from Coach Nick Hyder. It has to do with people.
All right, Billy.
Well, photographer Richard Crabb and I spent a day in Athens and a day in Valdosta. What we found here was pretty interesting, despite the fact the Wildcats have been to the final game so many times. Enthusiasm was a little slow to pick up speed here, too.
You've no doubt seen it and read about it. The Valdosta Wildcats have spent the season near the top of the national rankings. So what else is new? If the Wildcats aren't in the running for a championship, something's wrong. At least that's the impression you get in this South Georgia city of 40,000. But there's something you need to know about the community. The place that boasts of the Crescent House as its most famous landmark doesn't want to make a big deal about its real claim to fame. The welcome sign announces the area's two largest employers. No mention of the high school football team that has won 21 state and 5 national championships.
They don't get all excited. We don't have pep rallies like we used to have there. We have them occasionally, that type of thing. But it's all done now to, we play football after school, but the youngsters enjoy it. And you can see the numbers that we have out. That's the thing we're proud of.
But make no mistake, they are proud of hosting another championship game. When you've been among the elite for so long, you learn to pace yourself. Fan momentum is as important as team momentum, so the signs of encouragement around town early in the week were few but visible. While some merchants like Ivy Player base part of their livelihood on Valdosta's athletic success, they tend to take the cautious approach.
We look forward from one year to the next, one game at a time, and that's the way Coach Hyder likes us to do it, and that's the way we sort of accept things. We try to win each one of them that comes along.
And there's only one right way to do it, and that's the together way. It's the unselfish way. It's the way we get things done.
And they've been getting it done since 1913, a national best 701 wins. These are only a portion of the trophies and team mementos representing Wildcat success, from the first state title in 1940 to the most recent in 1990. The national awards, the legendary coach Wright Bazemore, and now the all-time winningest coach in Wildcat history, Nick Hyder. Around here, success breeds success, but they'll tell you it's all about priorities, not football.
School comes first. From 8 to 3, it's in the classroom, and then we'll go to the football field.
But among the students here, nearly 2,000 of them, pride is mixed with envy of the football program. Still, it's football that's bringing out the best.
It encourages everyone else to work harder because it's in the back of our minds that maybe if we achieve something at the level that they do, that we will get the same type of recognition.
Gentlemen, this coach is proud of you guys. This coaching staff is proud of you, and this town's proud of you. Let's see if we can make the state and the nation proud of us.
Randy and Fred will be back with more right after this.
Matumbo Bull played in the house of Matumbo by Matumbo. Matumbo Bull played in the house of Matumbo by Matumbo in his Matumbo shoe. Listen, you don't have his game and you don't have his house, but you can get his shoes in your size. Out.
It's McDonald's Holiday Film Festival, now featuring the American epic Dances with Wolves. The original full-length video, unbelievably priced at just $7.99 when you buy any large sandwich. So hurry in and pick up Dances with Wolves. Also available, the family favorite, Babes in Toyland, and the hilarious Dirty Rotten Scoundrels. These films just $5.99 each when you buy any large sandwich. What you want is what you get at McDonald's today.
Bell South's commitment to the United Negro College Fund is year-round. Hi, I'm Carl Swearingen. We believe in the value of education and put that belief into action. To encourage our employees' involvement, we match every donation 2-for-1. These funds provide students with new learning opportunities, utilizing the latest technology in telecommunications. Programs that once were only a dream have become a reality through Bell South. At Bell South, we join the UNCF in the belief that a mind is a terrible thing to waste.
There's nothing like the bond between a man and his truck. And right now, taking the plunge is easier than ever. It's a sure thing. For a limited time, Chevrolet's made it possible for dealers to get you an S10 pickup, equipped with the extras you're looking for, but without the extra cost. Yes, there's nothing as perfectly matched as a man and a truck. Unless, of course, it's a woman in a truck. The sure thing ends soon, so hurry to your Chevrolet dealer today.
Randy Waters and Fred Kallel back with you as Clark Central enjoys a 4-point lead over Valdosta's Wildcats here at Cleveland Field. And in the first half, Clark Central struck first. Let's take a look at some of the halftime statistics and see what they bear out as far as this 14-10 score goes here.
The Georgia Dairy Farmers halftime report, you can see first downs. Valdosta has come back strong to have 9 of those. 81 rushing yards, 57 passing yards. And even though Steve Everson didn't come out and throw more than normal. I thought that he actually came out and set up to throw, and that stretched the defense out, and he was able to run, and that's how he scored that touchdown.
Well, each team turned it over one time. There's only a 4-point difference, and we'll be back with our second half kickoff right after these messages.
This is an 11 Alive News update.
Good evening, I'm Carl Brown. Here's what's happening tonight. A 21-year-old woman is in good condition at Kennistone Hospital tonight after she was accidentally hit by a stray bullet inside a shopping mall. It happened in the food court of the Four Seasons Mall. A woman waiting in line to get a picture of her 16-month-old daughter with Santa Claus dropped her handbag with a loaded pistol in it. The gun went off. The bullet hit the other woman in her right hand and landed in her right thigh. Police arrested the gun-toting mom for not having a permit. Police in Kennesaw are holding an 18-year-old California driver who apparently didn't know what flashing blue lights behind him meant. Police tried to pull him over this afternoon when they spotted what they thought were fake tags. He took off on a high-speed chase along North Cobb Parkway. He finally flipped over in a grocery store parking lot and was arrested. DeKalb police were also involved in a chase this afternoon, only on foot. Several men had robbed a grocery store, but they crashed into a truck trying to make their getaway. They jumped out of their car, leaving the money and some automatic weapons behind, and took off running with police hot on their heels. Police are still looking for them tonight. And now Bonnie McLaughlin has the latest on the weather. Bonnie?
Thanks a lot, Carl. We take a look at our radar. You can see the wider area of rain is still to our west, but some spotty light areas of rain reported around the metro area and across northern Georgia. Doppler radar will show you again that we have these spotty areas of rain. They are moving towards the northeast at about 25 miles per hour. Drizzle, though, occurring right now in the city, but unfortunately it doesn't show up on radar. In our forecast for tonight, cloudy with rain, the overnight low about 49 degrees. And Carl, if it's not enough for you to have it now, we're going to have it tomorrow as well. More clouds, more rain, and a high of about 55. And it doesn't look like any great improvement in sight.
Okay, Bonnie, thank you. Well, that's it. We'll be back at 11 with a complete wrap of news, sports, and weather. Now back to the halftime of the Quad A football championship game.
Cleveland Field in Valdosta, where Joe Washington is down on the sideline with Nick Hyder.
Well, this was as advertised, a heck of a ball game. Coach Hyder, your team has been really strong defensively in the third quarter. Is this when you're going to have to stand up and be counted?
Well, so has the Clark Central team, and this is what a state championship game really should be. So we've got to stand up and go against a very well-prepared team, but we're real proud of our youngsters, and it makes it a real fine ball game for this second half.
Coach, I know you got to go. Good luck.
Thank you, Joe.
Randy, Fred, back to you.
Thank you, Joe. Three deep for Valdosta. They'll get the football first here. John Bell, Tommy Speed, and Nakia McMullen back for the Wildcats. As Clark Central set the kickoff, Rick Selleck will do that for the Gladiators, who lead by four. Two more quarters, and we will crown a Quad A state champion. Bell runs up to take it at a six. Across the 25 before he is tackled there by Frank Battle.
Frank Battle, number 91 in the white jersey. We've seen him in the first half, and I got a feeling now we're going to see him in the second half. The guy runs all the way down on the kickoff, runs it hard, steps into the first team defensive huddle.
All three touchdowns in the first half coming on the ground, but as Fred mentioned, it is the threat of the Valdosta passing attack that seems to have opened things up for them whenever they've been able to do something. And here are the Wildcats sticking on the ground for their first play from scrimmage in the third quarter. David Williams, the carry. Mike Daniels and Anton Goldwire team up for the tackle for Clark Central.
On the option, it's Mike Daniels. That's the guy that Steve Everson is reading. And that time, as he went to read Mike Daniels, Daniels just came in and stuffed the running back. Steve Everson so far, 8 of 13 for 57 yards.
He's got a second and seven now and a 28. And that time, Clark Central right at the line of scrimmage, stuffing the Valdosta run. David Williams nailed by Mike Daniels. Daniels' same name coming along more frequently, too.
Same play, same result. So now Valdosta looks at a third and six, and that really is going to be interesting to see what they call here.
again, as I mentioned, I have not seen 81 Shadrick Green involved in the passing game yet.
Chris Rocky and Bell are the wide receivers now. This is Barnes in motion, and Everson looking to his left for Bell. In between the zone, and he found the hole up to the 41-yard line for the first down. He's got six catches tonight.
Just a simple slant-in route. You can see Everson back to pass, getting good protection. And really, Bell is going to be wide open in the seam. He's too deep to get to the hook zone, which is what number seven Kevin Johnson has to play. And he is too shallow for the free safety to come up and make the play. That's when you hear about getting in the seam of the zone. That's what happened.
First down play here, and fumble on the play. Clark Central's on top of the football. Now, the question is, did they blow it dead? Was it dead? The officials are indicating the runner was down, and it will still be Valdosta's football. Alfred Barnes carried the ball, and the officials are spotting it. Valdosta's football.
Big, big break for Valdosta there. You know, that was a trap play. Jesse Hunter, the right offensive guard, number 52, pulled, but there was nobody to block, and he didn't turn it up. And consequently, the running back was able to turn it up and get a good game.
Three receivers to the right, but this is Everson, left side, trying to get to the 50, but a little bit shy. Ben Daniels stopped him.
It was really good run support from Ben Daniels that time, because Everson made a good read and kept the football, because Frank Battle, his option man, bit on the dive man.
Well, as you say, Fred, they're sure not afraid to run it to the short side, are they?
Yeah, I really think they like to run it to the boundary. And sometimes they'll put a man in motion and run the opposite direction.
Third and three, just shy of midfield, and no first down here, that's for sure. In fact, perhaps a fumble. Clark Central again indicating they have it.
Lots of things can happen on the bottom of a pile. We'll see who gets it.
Well, this one is taking a while. Clark Central's doing the preliminary celebrating, and in fact, they are happiest at the end as number seven comes back up from the bottom of the bunch, Kevin Johnson with the football.
Let's watch it from the end zone, Randy, and see what happened. Two backs in tight. Just a quick hitting play to Alfred Barnes, and he coughs it up right there. Nice defensive play by Reggie Smith, the nose guard.
All right, Clark Central's in business, so their first possession here in Valdosta territory, and Valdosta has turned it over twice tonight. And here comes Palmer Percy, end around, Kendrick Hall, and he's got a blocker in front, but he's also got a couple of mad cats in front of him, too, and he is shy of the line of scrimmage. The Anthony Roundtree over there to greet him.
Boy, Donald Hitson, the defensive end, also does a nice job. His job is contain and stay home. You see, he did not bite. Then he comes up and with his speed is able to help out on this play. Actually, he got buried on that play.
Well, but he had a couple of teammates there.
Teron Smith is making some great blocks.
But he couldn't get them all. He couldn't cover everybody. It is second and 12. And again, Kendrick, the guy who scored a touchdown, one of the touchdowns in the first half for Clark Central, is the ball carrier. Sam Thomas, the stop for Valdosta. So Clark Central will have a third down coming up here. Billy Henderson looking on. If he wins this game, his victory total as a high school coach would be 268, I believe, and that would tie him with the legendary Valdosta coach, Wright Bazemore. Third down play, and this is going to be shy of the first down by a couple. Kendrick carried it, and Franklin Wiseman stopped it.
Even though Clark Central did not make the first down, they'll be punting from about their own from Valdosta's, maybe their own 48-yard line, and they'll try to pin Valdosta back down there and force the Wildcats into some bad field position as you take a look at Nick Hyder's record in his 19th year here at Valdosta.
And he is 4-1 against Clark Central during that tenure. If he goes 5-1, he picks up this school's 22nd state championship, and some problems on the snap, but a good bounce for the Gladiators down inside the 15-yard line. And that's where Valdosta will take over.
Palmer Bush made that punt, Randy, and he is their pooch punter, if you will, when they want to nail it inside the 20, and that's what happened.
All right. Clark Central leads by 4. We're back after these messages.
Do you remember that story about the three bears?
This was too big.
That was too small. And finally, something fit just right. Like the J30 from Infiniti. Now that's my definition of luxury. It's a car you just slip right into and live happily ever after.
For a J30 signature lease, see your Infiniti dealer today.
Milk. You know milk's good for you. Drinking milk helps build strong bones and teeth. But did you know that the latest government research shows that the calcium in milk helps prevent certain types of cancer? And calcium combined with magnesium and potassium, all found in milk, can lower blood pressure. Or that milk is rich in vitamins and minerals needed for healthy skin and eyes. And protein to build muscle tone. Drink milk for health. Drink milk for life. A message from the Georgia Dairy Farmers.
McDonald's Holiday Film Festival, now featuring the American epic Dances with Wolves. The original full-length video, unbelievably priced at just $7.99 when you buy any large sandwich. So hurry in and pick up Dances with Wolves. Also available, the family favorite, Babes in Toyland, and the hilarious Dirty Rotten Scoundrels. These films just $5.99 each when you buy any large sandwich. What you want is what you get at McDonald's today.
Now, theoretically, Valdosta has more than a state championship at stake here. If they win, they are currently number one in ESPN's national high school poll, number two in USA Today's high school poll. Those national things are voted on and sort of mythical, but for real, the state championship, that's what goes in the scorebook. And Stephen Everson on the rollout and the keeper for Valdosta on the first down play there.
Good example of why Valdosta likes to run to the short side of the field. Number 91, Frank Battle, usually up on the line of scrimmage, is back almost in a linebacker spot. He is the drop end, and you see he has to come all the way back to make that play. Five tackles for Frank Battle in this ballgame.
But a first down for Everson and his Cats on the 29. McMullen, no room to the right side. Maybe a half yard or so. Godfrey McWhorter. The tackle for Clark Central.
Simple sweep play, pulling the guard, getting everybody out front. Just great pursuit that time by Clark Central to stuff it.
Everson in this offense, I was talking to the Valdosta coaches, and they said, mention some of our quarterbacks. And I said, well, who do you want me to mention? They said, John Lastinger, Buck Ballou, Greg Talley, Ted West, John Bond, who went to Mississippi State. They got a long list here. Everson with the ball over the 35, 40. And nearly to the 45-yard line. In fact, down at the 43, another first down for Valdosta.
We talked about when he rolls out, look out, because he wanted to, it looked like he wanted to throw the ball. He's looking to throw, doesn't like what he sees. He's got the Jesse Hunter, the pulling guard, out in front of him, and that's a great sprint-out package that Valdosta runs.
Those three receivers to the right, Fred, this time, 5 minutes to go, third quarter. And this is Tommy Speed fighting to the 48-yard line.
Take a look at this play from the end zone. Just a great, great run by Tommy Speed as he breaks tackles. See, Kevin Johnson misses the tackle there. He's finally horse-collared down there by Reggie Lewis.
He got five, so it's second. And, well, he got four, second and six. And the quick hitter out here to Bell, and he is going nowhere at all thanks to Ben Daniels.
Great play by Ben Daniels. Chris Rocky is going to come over to the sidelines and get an earful because he missed the block out there. Also, great pursuit by Kevin Johnson, one of the linebackers who just sprinted completely and took way out there. Now watch this quick pass right here. C7 coming into your screen, but look, Ben Daniels fighting off the block to make that play.
Third and three at midfield. Fumble. And again, Clark Central saying they have it, but it looks like Tommy Speed in the right spot for Valdosta. They'll still have to kick it away. That did prevent a turnover.
So the pooch kick by Palmer Bush is going to pay some dividends, as it appears. Clark Central gets some decent field position.
Eric Hurd back deep. Devane gets a high short kick. He's going to need a roll, and he gets a bit of one. In fact, a pretty good one. Pretty good roll for Valdosta down inside the 15-yard line, where Clark Central will take over, leading by four with just over 3 minutes to go here in the third quarter of play from Cleveland Field.
So much for that good field position.
He got a decent roll out of that. Well, Valdosta punched out a few first downs. And again, as a proud corporate sponsor of the Georgia High School Association, AT&T is pleased to recognize state champs in other activities. Girls cross country, quad A was Pope, triple A Westminster, double A Crim of Atlanta, and single A champion was Pace Academy. So congratulations to them. First and 10 on the 13. Off the right side, Kendrick. Franklin Wiseman tripped him up.
Valdosta in a stunt that time, and Antonio Speed in the ball game, number 46. He is usually playing behind Marcus Williams. He is going to play alongside him now.
Rip Kendrick ripped off five, so it's second and five on the 18. Palmer Bush the handoff. Kendrick again, and he is stopped.
Linebackers up there playing tough, a 50 tough look or a seven-man front, and really everybody just kind of got after it. James Robinson made the play.
Frankly, Fred, I'm surprised they don't have Nick Hyder up there. I mean,
they're bringing them. They are bringing people.
Clark Central has given them no reason to suspect anything in the secondary.
You know, the linebackers and defensive line, well, they work out a lot of things themselves right before the start of the play.
Third and seven. Bush on the rollout is not going anywhere. It'll be fourth down. Donald Hitson there for the Valdosta Wildcats.
Great play by Hitson. There. We're focused on Marcus Williams. You can see, look at Hitson come off that block, rip through, and make the play. Now watch. Williams also in on it. And he is happy.
Well, right now he ought to be from the field position Clark Central has to give up. But the scoreboard has the Gladiators in front. That's Bell at midfield. So Valdosta will take over there at midfield after taking the punt from Clark Central. The Gladiators lead by four. We've got 57 seconds left in the third quarter, and we'll be back after these messages from your local station.
If you shop any day at Cub Foods, you'll get a big bag full of savings with Cub Foods' assured minimum prices. But if you shop during Cub Foods' buy one, get one free sale, you'll double your savings. You'll discover items throughout Cub Food stores that you buy for your family every week. Only this week, you'll get two items for the price of one. So double your savings during Cub Foods' buy one, get one free sale. It's like getting two bags of groceries for the price of one.
North, south, east, west. The 14th annual Toyota Fun Year-End Challenge is on, going for 80,000 Toyotas nationwide.
Region to region, Toyota dealers are dealing.
With option package savings on cars up to $1,500, up to $850 on trucks, plus big incentives.
There's a great selection of Camrys, Tercels, all-new Corollas, and Toyota T100s.
The challenge is on. Who's going to win?
Our customers.
Right. You're the winner of the Toyota Fun Year-End Challenge. It only happens once a year.
And it's happening now.
One of my fondest memories of the Cantathon goes back about 8 years ago when the economy wasn't a lot better then than it is right now. We thought maybe this won't work because people are having a tough enough time on their own. But it did work. People turned out in tremendous numbers. Those who had a lot willing to share and those who could barely share what they had. It taught us all a great lesson. Even when times are tough, people really do care.
Drop your canned goods off at any Kroger store now through December 31st.
Tell them what it is, be a
Bulldog. 1992, Behind the Hedges.
We gotta have it, good job.
Giving you a rare look at a side of Georgia football you never see.
I need to get my gold in our camera lineup today.
From the strategy to the sidelines.
We got man-to-man every time, every single time.
Hastings got it, touchdown.
UGA, the 100-year season of Bulldog football. December 30th at 10 p.m. on 11 Alive.
Mike McMullen is a former Valdosta player who comes here at least once every year from Portland, Oregon to see a Valdosta game. You came to see a good one, Mike.
Yes. It'll be the first state championship I've seen since I played in the one in the 60s.
Okay. Mike says he's a little nervous. We'll let him watch the game. Fred Randy, back to you.
Well, Mike has reason to be nervous. He is down by four. Everson to Bell, who tries to throw, and it is incomplete down at the 21-yard line. Chris Rocky, the intended receiver.
He was over the line of scrimmage when he threw that second pass. And that's what that's the flag.
You can throw more than one pass in high school football. As Fred mentioned, if that second one, if you're over the line of scrimmage,
yeah,
that's a no-no. But two passes is not a violation.
Let's watch it again. Now you can see Bell, he starts going upfield. Watch, he's like, whoa, right there, and then backs up. His momentum kind of carried him. It's not really his fault. His momentum carried him there. He lets it rip, and Rocky could not get out to break free.
As it falls to the ground, we'll take a moment here to pause and let local stations identify themselves. Second and 15. Everson the pitch to McMullen. Down to the 41.
Toss play. Jesse Hunter, the guard, pulls, gets out there, and throws a nice block for McMullen. And it's a good gain right now. Valdosta looking at third and two. That penalty, that double pass, was a loss of down penalty. So it's third down.
Well, Clark Central calls a timeout with 14 seconds left, third quarter. And they saw Valdosta coming up for that third and one on the 40-yard line. And noticed something they needed to talk about. Billy Henderson's team leading by four, 14-10, as you can see.
Valdosta does not run that toss play a lot. They usually do it out of the I formation, which they seldom run. They're usually in the offset formation. Valdosta playing some great defense. Look at that, three and out. two possessions for Clark Central.
Well, Billy's been in coaching 42 years, been a head coach 32 years. He's weathered some rough quarters. But the key factor in that third quarter, despite his lack of productivity, is he still leads. All right, Class A championship in the fourth quarter. Bowden leading Macon County by the score of 12-6.
You know, Joe brought up a good point. Valdosta always plays tough D in the third quarter.
Well, we had 24 first half points scored, nothing in the third quarter as McMullen comes to the near side, and this is going to be close.
Again, the I formation, again, the toss play.
Last few seconds of the third quarter here have been lengthy.
Exactly. Ben Daniels made that hit. We'll see if it was close enough to make the play. Now, the referee's already picked up the ball from the spot. Now he's putting it back down. Or the official, rather, not the referee.
Well, they have to bring the chains all the way across to take a look at this one. It sure had everybody's attention, so it must have been very close, but they got it.
Got quiet there for a minute, didn't it?
Real quiet. Again, here we are looking at double A, and Mitchell Baker is leading by 9 in the fourth quarter there against Washington County. Valdosta sidelines as they try to come up with a go-ahead score. Clock will start on the snap. Everson to throw. Complete inside the 35. Chris Rocky the catch.
Simple pass pattern that time. John Bell, the speedster outside, runs off the defensive back. That way Rocky can go in underneath.
That is the end of the third quarter of play with Clark Central leading Valdosta 14-10. We'll be back after these messages.
This season, Pizza Hut's giving you something to celebrate. The Holiday Stuffer, a pizza loaded with 10 great toppings. Pepperoni, mushrooms and olives, Italian sausage, ham and bacon, beef and pork toppings, onions, even green peppers. Now at Pizza Hut, try one medium for a special price of $9.99. Any second pizza's half its menu price. But you'd better hurry, because when the season ends, so does the deal.
For free delivery, Atlanta's calling 662-5555.
I know. You see all of these car and truck companies announcing their end of the year sales, and you think, this is no time to be spending money on a new car. Well, Chevrolet couldn't agree with you more. So for a limited time, you can get a new Chevrolet or Geo for a great low price. Even better, you won't have to start paying for 3 months. I think that's very nice of Chevrolet. Don't you? The sure thing ends January 10th at your Chevrolet Geo dealer.
Matumbo Bull played in the house of Matumbo by Matumbo. Matumbo Bull played in the house of Matumbo by Matumbo in his Matumbo shoe. Listen, you don't have his game and you don't have his house, but you can get his shoes in your size.
Morning, Elsie.
Morning, Bessie.
Well, honey, another day, another gallon.
Ooh, how about 6 gallons? Mm-hmm. Now that's 660,000 gallons a day between all of us Georgia peaches.
Well, moo me.
From moo to you, Georgia can thank us for over 10,000 jobs.
Moo, moo, moo.
The milk industry contributes $700 million to Georgia's economy.
Well, moo, moo.
Now that's something to moo about.
Utterly amazing.
Mm-hmm. A message from the Georgia dairy farmers.
This man actually has three names. Legendary Wright Bazemore is what they refer to him as down here in Valdosta, the Valdosta head coach from 1941 and 1942, away for a brief span and then back, and 268 wins as Valdosta head coach, three national championships. His club down by 4 at the moment, and Everson was nailed as he unloaded that one. A All right, let's take a look at our Pizza Hut third quarter stats for you. First downs, Clark Central now has 4, Valdosta 13, and the rushing yardage, pretty even. Passing yards, well, that's a tremendous difference, but still, Fred, they haven't turned any of those passes into scores.
They have not, and Valdosta's run 15 offensive plays to Clark Central 6 in the third quarter.
Right side, McMullen cutting back left and getting down inside the 25 or right at the 25-yard line. Kevin Johnson, the stop for Clark Central.
Good cutback that time by McMullen to pick up the first down. So now Valdosta really in good shape. 25-yard line going in with a first down.
Early fourth quarter. Rocky and White are wide left. McMullen, Williams the backs. So this is Everson looking to throw. Looked for his tight end Green, then came back, found his secondary receiver. That's Tim White. And that was a fine job by Everson.
They had Green double teamed out there. Everson looked at him, looked him off, and then found Tim White. Look. See, he looked him off, bumped it, and found the secondary guy coming up wide open. That's usually what happens if you have a double team. You run those guys off, and that drag route is what we call it, is open across the middle.
And his offensive line gave him time to look for everybody, too. First and 10 at the 13. Everson to McMullen. And he's outside. And he's headed for the corner. And he's in for 6.
Great block that time by David Williams. Good seal block. That allowed McMullen to run right off his tail, take it into the end zone. Valdosta again, Randy, running away from the formation. Watch it. I want you to watch number 37 in the dark jersey as the play develops. Look at that seal block coming up, and he cuts right off, and that allowed McMullen to cut off. Extra points good. 17-14, Valdosta now, Rando.
That's only McMullen's second rushing touchdown this season, but they may remember that one for a long time down here because it has given the home team, the Valdosta Wildcats, a 17-14 lead over Clark Central with 11-11 to go here in the fourth quarter. Let's take another look and see how it develops.
There's 37 out in front of the play. Look at that great block. Great block on Ben Daniels. From the level. McMullen running hard. Can't arm tackle him.
Well, the sign at one end of the field says, "Welcome to Death Valley." A lot of visiting teams' hopes have faded away and died here indeed. Clark Central's a long way from dead, but they are down now by 3. Kendrick Hall. And he is stopped just over the 15. I'm sorry, that is Eric Hurd with the return for Clark Central.
8 plays, 49 yards. McMullen on the 13-yard run. Only took him 1:06 to drive it in.
Must have been Coach Bazemore.
Had to be.
Well, I'm sure he enjoyed it. Although he knows, Nick Hyder knows, Billy Henderson knows this one. A long way from being over. 10:55 left fourth quarter. Left side, Clark Central's Ricky Smith at the 16. Franklin Wiseman up there.
Wiseman made the play, but watch 97 again. Hits him. He gets blocked, but he comes out there with that speed, turns the play in, and then Wiseman makes the tackle. That's great speed.
Well, they told us yesterday, they said these two kids, Hitson and Wiseman, can outrun most running backs we've seen, and they were right. All right, 2nd and 9 for Clark Central. Deep in their own territory, and the draw play, and that didn't fool anybody. Ricky Smith surrounded, hits him, and DeAnthony Rountree, the initial contact, Joe Washington on the sideline. Joe?
Nakia McMullen gave the Wildcats a lead with that terrific run. The momentum is there. What do you guys got to do now?
The game's not over yet. Just got to keep playing our offense. And maybe, you know, we'll come out on top.
All right, thanks. Spoken like one of Nick Hyder's players, I'll tell you. There you go, Randy Fred.
Yeah, he's not making any bold predictions. He's not gonna deviate from the program at the moment. Third and nine, Mr. McMullen and his teammates, things are looking up for them, however. That's for sure. They lead by three, and Clark Central's in a hole right here on their own 17. Bush to throw. To the right side, his receiver was down, but the pass is completed, and that is a big, big third down conversion. Kerlin Payton, the reception, over the 30-yard line.
Blown coverage there, Randy. That was wide open. Unbelievably wide open. Watch it from the end zone camera. You can see the draw keeps Marcus Williams, the linebacker, in there.
Well, if he had been able to keep his feet, he could have really had some real estate, but I'm sure Clark Central is happy with the first down.
Jason Jumps has got to get to that flat area. He's got to get over to the outside.
From the 31, back to the ground game and back to Ricky Smith. Across midfield, the first down, Jason Jelks the stop.
Wiseman also came over and helped out on the play. Let's watch it develop. Blast play, kind of a delayed handoff. And Smith turns it into a great run. Watch it again. Look at that hole. Unbelievable hole.
And Smith can find him, too, when they're there. He's got a nose for him. 8:35, clock moving, fourth quarter. Clark Central driving. We are headed for one exciting finish. It's a three-point ball game as Rip Kendrick carries it, and Kevner Dyer on the hit for Valdosta.
Valdosta in the six-man front there. Marcus Williams, they like to let him run, let him get free, and let him make the plays. At that time, it was just a great surge by the Clark Central offensive line that allowed Kendrick to pick up 4 yards.
Gain of four, second and six. At the 44 of Valdosta. 8 minutes. Kendrick again, right side, and he's plowing toward that first down. Looks like he got it.
That time, Randy, Marcus Williams gambled and lost. He shot through there, tried to make a big play, but instead, Bush was able to get rid of the ball, hand it off. Kendrick made what appears to be the first down. Let's watch it. See, you see Marcus comes through right there and just gets caught up and can't make the play. That allowed Kendrick to go out. If he plays it straight, he might scrape over and make the play.
There's Marcus Williams, and he, along with everybody else, watching this measurement. And my eyesight's not really that good. I thought he actually got farther than that. He barely got the first down. Again, Clark Central opening up and stunning this crowd with two first quarter touchdowns. Valdosta coming back with 10 second quarter points. We had a scoreless third quarter, and Valdosta has taken the lead here with a touchdown in the fourth quarter. But Clark Central is driving at the Wildcats 39-yard line. Up the gut, Kendrick. Gain of about eight before Williams gets it.
Another good surge by the Clark Central offensive line. Marcus Williams made the tackle, but he made it downfield. Watch the surge. Look at that. Williams gets blocked, plays off the block, but still makes the play 8 yards downfield. So you got to be happy with your offensive guard getting into a guy like Williams. Even for that brief second, it leads to 8 yards.
Well, the officials, again, another equipment repair here.
Randy, I just want to say about Marcus Williams, I said that he gambled and lost on that play, but by no means, you know, was that a knock against him at all. You know, I think that Charles Tarpley, the defensive coordinator, trusts Marcus, you know, to make the plays, and if he sees something and he wants to do it, he's your starter, he's your leader. You have to let him play his game and have faith in him, and I know that Coach Tarpley and Hyder both have faith in Marcus Williams. He'll make a lot of big plays.
Jason Jelks, the Valdosta player, who had to come over and get a spare helmet because there was something wrong with his chin strap, and they would not let the game continue. This is the eighth play of the Clark Central drive. It's a second down play. They need a couple for a first down, and they're at the Valdosta 30. They've got the first down, and Stacy Daly has more inside the 20-yard line.
Great lead block that time by Kendrick. Super lead block to spring. Stacy Bailey, watch it, out of the I formation. 14 white jersey, bam! Great block.
The Valdosta,
Franklin Wiseman.
Valdosta crowd growing increasingly uneasy as Clark Central, now a nine-play drive, marches toward what would be a go-ahead touchdown. 54 yards covered so far in 4.5 minutes. They got a first down at the 18. Now punching down about the 15-yard line as that power for Clark Central beginning to tell.
We got some fresh defensive linemen coming in now for Valdosta. We talked about how Coach Hyder and Coach Starpley like to do that. They'll alternate what we call the TNT, the tackle, the nose tackle, and the other tackle.
Well, Rip Kendrick is doing some work on this drive, and that young man has been hurting. He had a bad shoulder against Marietta, and it's still hurting him here the last couple of weeks. And a valiant performance by him, a second and six play right now. Bush handing again as they stay up the middle. Jason Yearby in there on the stop. James Robinson for Valdosta.
There is Charles Tarpley, the defensive coordinator. And, you know, he commented to me that he's seen all of Coach Hyder's victories. And Coach Hyder's even missed one because he had a family emergency that took him out of town. Coach Tarpley in charge of the ball club. They won the ball game. So Billy Henderson, Clark Central sideline. Got to be happy with his offensive line. They are blowing people off the ball.
Well, they have a big third down here. They're 3 for 8 so far. They need 6 yards to convert this one. And they come to the left side with the pitch to Ricky Smith. And he's down inside the 10, and that's going to be close.
Again, Kendrick with a great block.
They'll take a look at it, and let us take a look at the play.
Straight ahead, dive blocking. 58, Mike Harper, a great block. Rip Kendrick over there making another good block, freeing Ricky Smith.
4:50 to go as they measure to see if Clark Central has indeed picked up another first down. Just inside the Valdosta 10-yard line. They got it. They got it, and the visiting side growing louder and louder. The Valdosta fans will be up on their feet, employing their defense to hold, but they're back on their heels a little bit right now. First and goal inside the 10. 17-14, Valdosta leading. Stacy Bailey barely had the football before the defense had him. Franklin Wiseman, the initial hit, and it was a good one.
He's got 9 tackles so far tonight. He's made some great plays for Valdosta. Let's watch it again. Now you see Marcus Williams. Now you see how he takes that extra blocker out. And then a great hit by Franklin Wiseman. When a guy like Williams blitzes, Randy, it changes the blocking scheme because they've got to pick him up, leave somebody free.
He lost a little bit on that. And so it's a second down and goal. Ricky Smith. And he lost a little more. Franklin Wiseman and Donald Hitson teaming up for the Wildcats.
Great play on defense. And really, we talked about the weird configuration power eye. That's what it is right there. You can see, 22 in the lineup. Curly Payton, he actually makes a nice block, but just too much pursuit. They are just flying to the football now.
Another big third down play, and they've converted a couple of them here in this drive, but here's a third and goal just outside the 10. This drive, or this possession, rather, this series of downs started inside the 10, and they've lost a couple. So now they're back outside the 10 with a third and goal.
Clark Central, 3 of 8 on third down conversions. 14th play of this drive, and they are eating up some time.
73 yards covered so far. If they cover 83, they're in front. And they stick it on the ground, and Stacy Bailey in the middle of the field is nailed by DeAnthony Roundtree. And I say middle of the field because they'll now try the field goal.
You know, Marcus Williams in on that play as well. He made something happen. And the defense for Valdosta steps up when they have to, as this time is running out.
A little bit of heat on the young man's shoulders who is going to try this field goal for Clark Central. Matt McNeil. The spot is at the 18. So a 28-yard attempt. Snap good, hold good, and it is up and wide left. Wide left. 2:28 to go, and Valdosta still leads by 3. It is 17-14. We'll be back at Cleveland Field in Valdosta following these words from your local stations.
Want to lower your golf score? It's easy. Do what I do. Get a pencil with an eraser on it. And make sure you get your golf equipment at the Sports Authority.
Find the biggest selection of Harvard table tennis tables and complete accessories, and the ProForm Edge 2001 electronic home gym with 7 stations and push-button resistance.
Looks like a 3-wood just to get to the cash register.
The Sports Authority. You've never seen anything quite like it.
It's McDonald's Holiday Film Festival, now featuring the American epic Dances with Wolves. The original full-length video, unbelievably priced at just $7.99 when you buy any large sandwich. So hurry in and pick up Dances with Wolves. Also available, the family favorite, Babes in Toyland, and the hilarious Dirty Rotten Scoundrels. These films just $5.99 each when you buy any large sandwich. What you want is what you get at McDonald's today.
Pell South's commitment to the United Negro College Fund is year-round. Hi, I'm Carl Swearingen. We believe in the value of education and put that belief into action. To encourage our employees' involvement, we match every donation 2-for-1. These funds provide students with new learning opportunities, utilizing the latest technology in telecommunications. Programs that once were only a dream have become a reality through Bell South. At Bell South, we join the UNCF in the belief that a mind is a terrible thing to waste.
Tell them what it is to be a Bulldog.
1992, Behind the Hedges.
We gotta have it. Good job.
Giving you a rare look at a side of Georgia football you never see. From the strategy to the sidelines.
We got man-to-man every time. Every single time.
Hastings got it. Touchdown!
UGA, the 100-year season of Bulldog football. December 30th at 10 p.m. on 11 Alive.
In Valdosta, in Athens, and elsewhere around the state, they are going to be talking about this field goal attempt for some time to come, and we're going to add some fuel to the fire, I think, with our replay, Fred.
Look at this. Ooh. Ooh, that's close.
Awfully tough to tell without the ability to stand beside the goalpost and see it from that angle, but from behind, it looked like it was inside the upright before it tailed left, or hooked left, rather. All right, Valdosta in the lead and looking to chew up time as McMullen carries the ball. And Frank Battle there again.
Battle coming up with 7 tackles tonight. 2 minutes left in this one. Look at that.
Boy, that's going to be a hot topic, Fred.
I'd say.
You got a feel for Matt McNeil. Young man, only had 3 field goals all year. The kicking department, not a strength of Clark Central, and he had a chance to tie it up, and officials say it was wide. And this is Speed, who has stopped short of the 25 with a minute 40 to go. And Clark Central is going to stop the clock now, too.
You know, if I had a running back, I'd want a Tommy Speed. This is a great name for a running back.
Not a bad name for a NASCAR driver either, Lake Speed.
That's right.
All right, Billy Henderson looking at a three-point deficit at the moment. 17-14 Valdosta, back after these messages.
Ladies and gentlemen, feast your eyes on the elegant J30. A classic luxury sedan in an infinity kind of way. A driver's car with two airbags, soft leather appointments, and tasty wood. Hey, pal, don't you even think about it.
For a J30 signature lease, see your Infiniti dealer today.
No, no, no. That's not the M Squad.
No.
Uh-uh. This is the M Squad, and this is how you recognize it. The M Squad by Fila.
Christmas trees, a holiday tradition. Hi, I'm 11 Alive Earthwatch reporter Mark Picard. Most of us are going to try to find the perfect shape and size, but what are we going to do with our trees when the holidays are over? Well, 11 Alive News has the perfect solution. Recycle. On January 2nd and 3rd, Saturday and Sunday, bring your old trees to any Home Depot location and get a free seedling while supplies last. It's 11 Alive's Christmas Tree Recycling Weekend at Home Depot. A good way to start the new year.
If you need information on money, health and nutrition, educating your children and more, then you need the free consumer information catalog. Do whatever it takes, but make sure you get this address. New catalog, Pueblo, Colorado, 81009. Yes.
This season, Pizza Hut's giving you something to celebrate. The Holiday Stuffer, a pizza loaded with 10 great toppings. Pepperoni, mushrooms and olives, Italian sausage, ham and bacon, beef and pork toppings, onions, even green peppers. Now at Pizza Hut, try one medium for a special price of $9.99. Any second pizza's half its menu price. But you'd better hurry, because when the season ends, so does the deal.
For free delivery, Atlanta's calling 662-5555.
The Valdosta cheerleaders are hoping to have a big, big pre-Christmas celebration in a minute and 38 seconds of playing time. Valdosta leads 17-14, but they have a third and six on their own 24 on Clark Central, chopping at the bit to get another shot, to get the ball back. And here's Everson with some sleight of hand and quickness of foot, and he is out with a big first down to the 43-yard line.
How many times have we said it, Randy? This guy makes the plays you need. He makes big plays. He made a great read that time. And again, look at it. Gets everybody to fight Mike Daniels' bit on that fake. And when he comes around the perimeter, it's over. And again, by putting those receivers out to the wide side of the field, that way you take your defensive backs, you take those people out, they're out a little bit farther, makes the corner easy to get to.
Everson had that ball so far into Tommy Speed's belly. Tommy might want some credit for some of that yardage on that run.
He did pull it at the very last second.
Down to a minute 10, minute 9, clock moving. Clark Central at the moment can do nothing about it as Valdosta takes the penalty for delay of game, and it stops at 1 minute and 5 seconds as Everson and his offense will go back now and set up with a first and 15 at their own 38. Now we mentioned all those Valdosta quarterbacks, and they'll be talking about this kid now like they do some of those other ones.
Clark Central with two more opportunities to stop the clock. We'll see what happens. They put him in another third down situation. Conceivably, he'll get the ball back.
Valdosta will try to chew up the time on the ground. Clark Central immediately gets the attention of the officials to call the timeout. Proud corporate sponsor of the Georgia High School Association. We want to give AT&T a chance to recognize state champions crowned in other activities. And our list of champions includes literary activities. Champions in one-act plays in Quad A, Mount Zion, and Jonesboro. Triple A, Perry. Double A, Harlem. And Class A, Claxton. Scholarships in football aren't the only thing that come out of some of these young men's activities in the game. Billy Henderson has had a number of kids go on academic scholarships. In fact, Billy Henderson, everybody in Athens knows this, he's gotten helped a lot of kids get scholarships from Cedar Shoals, from other schools. Valdosta getting ready for the party.
They are. They've got to make a couple of more plays to put this one out of reach.
7 seconds went off the clock that last time.
Right. Started with 1:05.
Class A, it's over. Bowden has defeated Macon County. The final there, 13-6. Mitchell Baker, double A, leading Washington County by 9. That score has remained the same for a while. That's in the fourth. 2nd and 17. And again, Everson, the predictable, down on one knee. The Valdosta sideline voicing their opinion that he shouldn't have been hit, but I think the officials realized that Clark Central wants that ball so badly they weren't trying to hurt anybody, just get there and try to make something happen.
Now, 3rd and long. Got 25 seconds to get a playoff. It's going to be, unless they convert this first down, it's 3rd and 18. Clark Central's going to call timeout. They most likely to get the ball back.
Well, Valdosta is going to, I thought they were going to take the delay game right here. Nope, they're coming up.
I don't think they can go back 5 more.
Yep, they're going to. They are going to with 17 seconds left. Well, this could get real interesting. 17 seconds. Now we have a Triple A final for you. Oh, a close one. Thomas County Central, as Peach County missed a 2-point conversion attempt that would have given them the championship. And Thomas County Central wins at 14-13. 3rd and 23, the yardage insignificant. The time is the factor here. So 14, Clark Central, no timeouts, can do nothing about it. So you can watch the final few seconds tick off and Valdosta celebrate another state championship, 17-14. All right, again, your final. Valdosta 17, Clark Central 14. We have crowned our Quad A state champion, and we will be back after these messages.
This is an 11 Alive News update.
Good evening, I'm Carl Brown. Stories making news tonight. Two teenage girls who tried a daring armed robbery at a local Crystal's restaurant are still not in custody tonight. Atlanta police say the girls, thought to be ages 15 and 12, went into the Crystal's on Moreland Avenue at I-20 this morning with loaded shotguns. Police say they fired several shots but didn't hit anyone, and they never got any money. Atlanta police want to find who shot and killed a man dressed like a woman. The transvestite was found dead in the yard of this home in southwest Atlanta. He was wearing a wig and earrings, but that's about all police know about who the person is. They're not sure if this death has anything to do with 4 other transvestite murders the past year. A Carroll County man who saw his home blown away during last month's tornadoes is back under a roof tonight thanks to some helpful neighbors. Ulyss Bass didn't have any insurance to rebuild his trailer, but volunteers from the Carroll County Home Builders Association chipped in to build a new one for him. Bass will be living in a 2-bedroom house. All the materials were donated, and the labor was done without costing him a cent. And now Bonnie is in with a quick look at our forecast. Bonnie?
Thanks a lot, Carl. Here's a look at the latest Doppler radar, and you can see the area of rain is definitely headed towards the state of Georgia. Now that rain is slipping across the Alabama border up towards Rome. More light rain showers are being reported around the metro area, along with some drizzle, which is not being picked up very well by radar. And it looks as though we are in for a wet night and a wet Sunday. In our forecast for tonight, cloudy with rain, the overnight low dropping to about 49 degrees. And then for tomorrow, we'll have a cloudy with rainy day and a high around 55. Carl?
All right, Bonnie, thank you very much. And as you saw here tonight, it was a very exciting game, that Quad A championship. That's it for now. We'll have a complete wrap-up of all the day's news following our coverage of tonight's Quad A High School Football Championship. And now, let's return you to Valdosta for the wrap-up of tonight's big game.
Valdosta has chalked up its 22nd state championship. They still have hopes of being named number one in a couple of national polls, although the team from Pennsylvania that was number one with Valdosta number two in one of those national polls also won up north today. So I think Valdosta right at the moment is content to concentrate on winning the state championship.
No question about that. Steve Everson doing a great job again getting that big first down and enabled Valdosta to run out the clock and win the state title 17-14. But as you said, Berwick of Pennsylvania winning their game big handily 33-6. So there's still the ESPN poll that has Valdosta ranked number one, and they could still win that national championship.
Well, and to talk about the people who made it happen, I think I would have to go with Everson as the guy who made it happen most here. He didn't throw for touchdowns, but he kept that defense worried about him opening up the field.
Exactly. Anytime he sprinted out, he had blocking ahead of him. It really, really stretched the defense out and allowed Valdosta to make plays. They stretched him out all night long.
All right. The guys who made those plays are with Joe Washington right now down in the Valdosta locker room. Joe?
Yeah, and I'll tell you what, you guys were talking about that national title, but I don't even think they've taken 1 second to think about that. One of the first players who walked in said, "We're number one, baby," and they're talking about Georgia. They're not worried about the rest of the country right now. Happy group, man. Come on over here, man. Come on over here, man. Now, this has got to be feel good to be a part of something like this.
Yes, it does. It's great. I love it.
What did Coach Hyder tell you guys at halftime?
He has told us he still loves us.
Oh, man. That was it. Coach Hyder told you he loved you, and that's what carried you through the second
half. He mean it too, baby. When he told us that we love him, we trusted him. We came from behind, baby. We know we get down, baby. We're number one, baby.
Well, as you can see, when you get in with a group like this, you're in for just about anything. And these guys are truly, truly happy to be the number one Triple A Quad A team in the state of Georgia. Fred and Randy, if you were trying to say something to me, I couldn't hear you because my earpiece has been pulled out. But needless to say, this is one heck of an evening. And the Clark Central Gladiators have nothing to hang their heads over. They played a tough game, a team that came in here into Death Valley. They were not... Clark Central was not favored. They were not the favorite, and they had to face a hostile crowd for the most part. They brought down 10 busloads of fans, and they pulled it off. This was indeed a big, big win for them. All right, here we go. I can hear things again. I'll tell you what, we're going to be back with this group in just a couple of minutes.
Milk. You know milk's good for you. Drinking milk helps build strong bones and teeth. But did you know that the latest government research shows that the calcium in milk helps prevent certain types of cancer? And calcium combined with magnesium and potassium, all found in milk, can lower blood pressure. Or that milk is rich in vitamins and minerals needed for healthy skin and eyes, and protein to build muscle tone. Drink milk for health. Drink milk for life. A message from the Georgia Dairy Farmers.
Just because the 80s are over doesn't mean you have to stop looking out for number one, especially when Chevrolet makes it so easy for you. For instance, for a limited time, Chevrolet has made it possible for dealers to get you a new Lumina equipped with the extras you're looking for, but without the extra cost. Now, who said the 90s were going to be dull? The sure thing is going on now. See your participating Chevrolet dealer.
No, no, no. That's not the Ant Squad.
No.
This is the Ant Squad, and this is how you recognize it. The Ant Squad by Fila.
The Center for the Visually Impaired provides a bright beginning for children who are blind or partially sighted. For information on the center's Begin program, please call 875-9011.
It's McDonald's Holiday Film Festival. now featuring the American epic Dances with Wolves. The original full-length video, unbelievably priced at just $7.99 when you buy any large sandwich. So hurry in and pick up Dances with Wolves. Also available, the family favorite, Babes in Toyland, and the hilarious Dirty Rotten Scoundrels. These films just $5.99 each when you buy any large sandwich. What you want is what you get at McDonald's today.
Randy Waters and Fred Khalil back with you live from Cleveland Field in Valdosta, where the Wildcats have won another state championship, final 17-14. They also sacked Joe Washington in the locker room there moments ago. We will take a look at the scoring plays from this championship, this Quad A championship game for you. First of all, Ricky Smith for Clark Central, and once he broke the line of scrimmage, it was good night.
You know, another good block that time by Rip Kendrick and Teron Smith. That allowed Ricky Smith to get in the clear, and when he did, he cut back nicely. And a 46-yard touchdown run had Valdosta on their heels. It was 7-0, but that was not all.
Well, Rip Kendrick, a 21-yarder, put him up 14-0, and it really looked like that Clark Central ground game was really going to roll.
Weston Webb had the key block there, sealing off Marcus Williams, and then it was history.
Well, but you don't win 702 high school football games without the ability to come from behind. Steven Everson here, a 10-yard run for the touchdown.
He wanted to pass the football, saw nothing there, tucked it and ran, and that's what he does so well. Here's the final touchdown of the ball game.
Well, after the field goal, closed it to a 4-point game. Valdosta with the 13-yard run from Nakia McMullen.
And David Williams, number 37, making the final seal block there that really set Nakia in there for the end zone.
Well, again, the final 17-14, and Joe Washington back down in the Valdosta locker room. Joe?
Yeah, and I'm alive, too. Chris Gingro, one of the Wildcats' offensive linemen. I'll tell you what, you couldn't pass the ball the way you wanted to, but you linemen had to do the job to get it going on the ground, and you did just that.
Yes, sir, I feel they were a tough team all along and everything, and they kept playing tough, but the line pulled it together, the backs found the holes, and we just pulled it together tonight, and we did a great job.
Al, they came out like a ball of fire in the first half. You know, what did you guys say to each other? Because you knew you had to pull it together.
We just said we got three more quarters. We can do it. We can come back. We've done it all year long. We just stay together. Don't separate. Just keep playing together and everything. We just do good.
Now, that team from Berwick, Pennsylvania, won the game. You know, they were number one in the country in some polls. You guys were number two. I don't know. What do you think about that? You're number one in Georgia.
Well, I've been in Pennsylvania before. I think South Georgia is a lot tougher than Pennsylvania. I've lived there for 3 years, so I think South Georgia, we should win it. We're number one and two of the three polls, so I don't know. We're just getting our championship there.
Yeah, it doesn't matter at this point, does it? Chris, thank you. Congratulations. I'll tell you what, we're going to keep rolling in here and try and pick up some more interviews. We're going to try and, of course, get Steve Everson, our player of the game. But right now, these guys are full of it, man. They are state champions and loving every minute of it. We'll be back right after this.
This season, Pizza Hut's giving you something to celebrate. The Holiday Stuffer, a pizza loaded with 10 great toppings. Pepperoni, mushrooms and olives, Italian sausage, ham and bacon, beef and pork toppings, onions, even green peppers. Now at Pizza Hut, try one medium for a special price of $9.99. Any second pizza's half its menu price. But you'd better hurry, because when the season ends, so does the deal.
For free delivery, Atlanta's calling 662-5555.
I know. You see all of these car and truck companies announcing their end of the year sales, and you think, this is no time to be spending money on a new car. Well, Chevrolet couldn't agree with you more. So for a limited time, you can get a new Chevrolet or Geo for a great low price. Even better, you won't have to start paying for 3 months. I think that's very nice of Chevrolet. Don't you? The sure thing ends January 10th at your Chevrolet Geo dealer.
Matumbo Bull played in the house of Matumbo by Matumbo. Matumbo Bull played in the house of Matumbo by Matumbo in his Matumbo shoe. Listen, you don't have his game and you don't have his house, but you can get his shoes in your size out.
Morning, Elsie.
Morning, Bessie.
Well, honey, another day, another gallon.
Ooh, how about 6 gallons? Mm-hmm. Now, that's 660,000 gallons a day between all of us Georgia peaches.
Well, moo me.
From moo to you, Georgia can thank us for over 10,000 jobs.
Moo, moo, moo.
The milk industry contributes $700 million to Georgia's economy.
Well, moo, moo.
Now, that's something to moo about.
Utterly amazing.
Mm-hmm. A message from the Georgia dairy farmers.
Waiting to come out of a commercial. Okay. Okay, we're with defensive end Frankie Wiseman. Frankie, I know it was a tough battle for you guys. They showed you something tonight.
Yes, sir. They played great ball. You know, we know it wasn't going to be easy, you know, because that's a great team. They outsized it. They came out of hard. They played real good.
Well, one thing that held true for you guys, you proved you were a tough third quarter team, and you held when it counted tonight.
Yes, sir. You know, we worked hard and everything. You know, we know it was going to come down to the last while. You know, we just wanted to pull out the big win.
Well, they talk about pride and all that around here. I'm going to show you pride, okay? Ninth grade, Wildcats. 7-0. They start them real young here. They start them in the seventh grade in the feeder program, and they bring them on up through the system. That's why these guys are champions for the 22nd time. All right, Randy and Fred.
All right, Joe, thank you very much. Time now for us to take a look at our Pizza Hut game summary and take a look at the numbers here. Hotlanta's calling Pizza Hut. And now let's see what we have reflected here. And first downs, Valdosta, the clear edge there, rushing yardage. Clark Central, as we expected in the passing yards, it's Valdosta. The total yardage, Fred, really, that's not much of a difference.
Not much of a difference at all, and Valdosta even turned the ball over more than Clark Central. So usually the team that rushes the ball more is wins the ball game. But this one, obviously, when
ESPN presents the youth of America doing their best on Scholastic Sports America. ESPN Scholastic Sports America is brought to you by Coca-Cola and your local Coca-Cola bottler. And by McDonald's, home of the new McDonald's guarantee. South isn't exactly little, but it's not every day that a community can boast about a national championship. Well, actually, the folks in Valdosta can boast more than most. You see, the Wildcats of Valdosta High School are getting used to these kinds of accolades when it comes to its football team. After all, this is the winningest high school football team in the country, and they seem to get better with every decade. They owned the 80s with a record of 153 wins, 11 losses, and one tie. In the 90s, they've been just about unbeatable. So far in this decade, they are 38-1-1. They've won 3 of the last 4 Georgia State Championships, 6 of the past 11, and 22 overall. How do the Wildcats come by all this success? Well, Nick Heider, who's been the head coach here for the past 17 seasons, will tell you it has more to do with tradition than pure talent. As one alumnus told me, teams that play Valdosta hope to win, while the Wildcats expect to win. Therein lies the difference. And while other teams may boast about their offensive power, Valdosta points to its defense. This season, the Wildcats recorded 6 shutouts, which allowed the offense to outscore their opponents 335-61. The most points allowed in a single game this season was 14, and that was in the state championship. And so with stats like these in hand, we made our way to the Azalea City, certain that we were honoring the finest high school football team in the land.
You guys are to be credited, you out there and you here. It is with pride that I present to the Valdosta Wildcats our 1992 National Football Championship trophy. ESPN is proud to recognize you, you there, and these people up here as the finest football team in America. Congratulations to Valdosta. Coach and the captains.
Shortest speech ever made. We did it. Make this real short. On behalf
behalf of my teammates and myself, we'd like to thank everybody for the support and ESPN for this award. And we're going to college, and we're going to be back, and we want to see another one of these.
Once again, the Valdosta High Wildcats are 1992 SSA National High School Football Champions. Congratulations.